Opening day 2021 for Major League Baseball. First home run of the season amid snow flurries belongs to Miguel Cabrera. Tigers leading the Indians 3-0 bottom eight. On ESPN TV, Blue Jays and Yankees still tied at two, bottom eight. Pirates leading the Cubs 3-2 top of the fourth. Bottom of the fourth, Twins with a 2-1 lead on the Brewers. Phillies have a 1-0 lead on the Braves, bottom third. North Carolina basketball coach Roy Williams is retiring, stepping away after 33 total seasons. Tar Heels won three national championships in his 18-year tenure at UNC. His 903 career wins, fourth most among D1 coaches. He's among the all-time greats, believes Syracuse coach Jim Boeheim.
Roy Williams is there. I mean, he's right there in the conversation. He's as good as coach as anybody for what he did in Kansas and North Carolina. Incredible success. You know, he'll be missed in the college game.
Oklahoma State phenom Cade Cunningham will enter the NBA draft as expected. He is the top overall draft prospect, according to ESPN.
What? Just 15 seconds to talk about Twisted Tea Hard Iced Tea? That smooth taste of real brewed iced tea with just the right kick of alcohol? What? We started already? Twisted Tea Hard Iced Tea. Look for it in the bright yellow cans. Twisted Tea Brewing Company, Cincinnati, Ohio. Please drink responsibly.
Matt Moscona.
I'm very important.
After further review.
Say one more time.
After further review with Matt Moscona.
And here we go.
ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria. Live from the Mercedes-Benz of Baton Rouge Studios.
That's right.
Off we go. Welcome aboard. Glad you're with us. AFR presented by the Aesthetic Medicine and Anti-Aging Clinics of Louisiana. I'm Matt.
I appreciate it, bud. Have a good one.
Paul O'Neill.
They're chanting Paul O'Neill's name.
The Brain.
Hey, the Brain got a poop.
And Mr. Toby Tomplay. All right, we're here. Glad you are as well. Get out there and make it a good one. 3.5 hours away from first pitch, LSU Vanderbilt, the number one team in all the land at the box here this weekend. Excited for it. We will preview that. Mike Detillier next hour. And plenty of goings on around college athletics. Mark Emmert today met with some college basketball players who had been wearing the hashtag not NCAA property shirts during the NCAA tournament, if you've seen any of that. Really a kind of a pivotal day, it seems, with the NCAA appearing for the Supreme Court yesterday and with all the NIL conversations going on. We'll have that conversation a bit later in the show. Glad you're here. It is opening day in baseball as well. Brain, how are you feeling about opening day? How are the Mets doing today?
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Could you hear Paul laugh?
I did. Because he's the one that told me about it earlier.
Paul, how are the Braves doing today?
I believe we're down 1-0 right now.
Yeah, 1-0, bottom of the third to Philly.
Still time left.
Special franchise to be half a game back before throwing a pitch.
How about that? The New York Braves, New York Metropolitans. But you did spend like $300 million today.
It's a good thing.
That's good.
It is.
Like a Bobby Bonilla contract.
$1 million a year for the next 300 years.
You're known for your contracts. How about that? Something to be known for, Brain?
Yeah.
All right. Yankees and Blue Jays are tied at two because I know you care. Top of the ninth. All right. We'll keep an update on goings on opening day around Major League Baseball. It is a fun day. So hopefully whoever your team is, whoever it is you pull for, hope you're having a good day regardless of how the other results go. Remember, after this one, you've only got 161 more. So there's plenty of these things to go around. For LSU Baseball, they are six games into their conference schedule, meaning there are 24 to go, and one of them is tonight. It is LSU against Vanderbilt. It is Landon Marceau against Kumar Rocker. These two pitchers from Vanderbilt, we've talked about a ton. They are absolutely incredible. Rocker with a .73 ERA. Is it possible? How is this possible? Kumar Rocker is 6-0. He's got a .73 ERA. He has 53 strikeouts in 37 innings pitched. And nobody's even talking about him because they're talking about the other guy who's got a 0.25 ERA with 59 strikeouts in 36 innings pitched, Jack Leiter. And if there is a good thing for LSU about Vanderbilt having the best staff ERA in the SEC at 227, it's that Vanderbilt also has the best batting average in the SEC at 313.
You said something about a good thing?
Right. I was just trying to distract you. Just make sure you're paying attention. But you know what the great thing is, Brain, is that even though they can hit for average at 313, they don't really hit for power because they're fourth in the country in home runs.
You're not setting a pretty table, Matt.
You know, Tim Corbin's built a machine. I mean, this is, of all the great teams they've had at Vanderbilt, I mean, this one at this point is probably his best. I mean, I know that's a mouthful because they've won a couple of national titles, and you've seen guys like David Price roll through there, but college baseball hasn't seen a 1-2 punch like Rocker Leiter since, we've talked about it a bunch. I mean, since you had Garrett Cole and Trevor Bauer at UCLA, and then on top of it, the way that they can hit for average and for power, this is an incredible baseball team, and the challenge is there. What I would tell you is Vanderbilt has lost twice this year, and they were games on the weekend when they lost, and both were game threes. They lost with Thomas Schultz, who's a sophomore righty. He's 2-2 on the season. He's got a 5.14 ERA. From the beginning of the season, the thing that I've said about LSU is their best opportunity to win series is going to be win game three, because you have a decided advantage with A.J. Labus on the bump because you have a guy that's played so much baseball and thrown so many key innings in conference play throughout his career. And you can run Labus out there, and most teams don't have a number three like that. So it gives you an advantage. So can you split the first two, find a way to win game three with Labus on the bump, and that's your path to win a series? I'm not saying it's something LSU will do or is expected to do this weekend, but can they do it? Sure, because it's baseball, and baseball's weird, and funny things happen, and you can run into a ball, a pitcher doesn't have his best stuff, makes a mistake, leaves one over the plate, and you can hit it 400 feet and change the scoreboard. So the challenge is very sincere. LSU Vanderbilt game 1, 6:30 tonight. Tomorrow, 8 p.m. for game 2. And then game 3 on Saturday is going to be a 2 o'clock matinee. Specifically talking about Rocker and Leiter, Paul Maneri, when he met with the media, did talk about the challenge in facing those two.
It's a great challenge for our guys, and I think it's a challenge that our kids are really looking forward to. And you know, we're not going to cower. You know, we're gonna rise up and enjoy the opportunity. And like I tell our players, you know, your aspirations are to play in the major leagues. Well, these are the caliber of pitchers you're going to face in the major leagues. So if you really do vision yourself as a major league ball player, those are the kind of pitchers that you have to be able to hit. You know, you either rise up and meet the challenge, or, you know, you better taper down what your expectations for your own career are.
That is very true, that you will face guys like that in Major League Baseball. The difference is those guys could be pitching in Major League Baseball now and shouldn't be pitching against college hitters. There's a reason why they are dominating the way they are, because they're playing at a level they shouldn't be playing at right now. As far as the lineup, we're waiting for the lineup to be posted. We do kind of get a sense from Paul Maneri that we're expecting Collier Cranford to be at second and for Will Safford to be in center. Maneri kind of explained why.
With the wind blowing in this weekend, which is what the forecast is for, I have this sense that the games are going to be rather low scoring, you know, the caliber of the pitching, you know, and the wind blowing in, the cold air. So I'm at second base. I'm probably going to lean towards the defense, and that would probably lean towards Collier Cranford being our second baseman. I think his range, his steadiness, his speed, if we can get on base, all those things would probably be the way that we would go. And in center field, I think that even though, you know, Will struck out a couple times last night, I just really like Will's hustle and his speed in the outfield. He did get a nice base hit yesterday. I do think that that at times he shows that he can turn around a good fastball.
Will Safford has done that. We've talked about a bunch throughout fall that that's kind of been his MO. I mean, he was the second best hitter behind Dylan Cruz all throughout fall, and I think he needs to be in the everyday lineup. I'm not super keen on taking Zach Arnold out of the lineup and having Collier Cranford in the lineup. While I do understand what Paul Maneri is saying, you think it's going to be a low-scoring game, low-scoring series, you want defense in there. I understand to a degree because defense did cost you in the first game against Tennessee last week. You had the misplay in center field. You had three pass balls from Hayden Stravinsky at catcher, including one that allowed a run to score. And I do understand that. I also think it's one of those things where you need bats in the lineup. You've got to be able to produce runs because Vanderbilt is going to score, and you're going to have to find a way to generate offense against these pitchers. Either that, or you're going to have to find a way to get those pitchers out of the game and get into the bullpen. One more, by the way, from Paul Maneri, who did talk a little more about Will Safford playing out there in center.
You're never going to question Will's hustle. You're never going to question his toughness. You're never going to question his desire and his passion and his competitiveness. And I think he's got a chance to make some really good catches in the outfield. I think he's got a chance. He can bunt a little bit. He's got speed if he can get on base. And I do think he's going to hit. He hit a ball in Tennessee if the wind was not blowing in. That would have definitely been a two-run home run. I'm going to stick with Will this weekend and see how he performs. And I think he's going to go out there and let it rip and do some good stuff for us.
I'd really like giving Will Safford the opportunity to play over three games and see if he can generate that offense, because it's something you've been missing. It's something you thought you were going to have this year. Paul Maneri said all leading up to the season, you know, if the season started today, Will Safford was going to be your starting third baseman. He's a guy that needs to be in there and needs to be in the lineup, and this is a good opportunity to give him. The challenge is sincere, but you got a guy that knows how to get on base. Let's see if he can maybe have a big weekend. All right, it is LSU and Vanderbilt, 6:30 first pitch tonight. If you're in Baton Rouge, you can hear it on Eagle 98.1. All right, let me knock out a quick break, y'all. When Mike Detillier in about 48 minutes from right now, when we come back, Todd McShay has his latest mock draft out, and it's a two-round mock draft, and I absolutely despise what he did for the New Orleans Saints. We'll talk about it next on AFR.
AFR.
Better coverage for less money. That's Insurance Network of Louisiana. The guys and gals over at Insurance Network of Louisiana, they go shop to see if they can find you better insurance coverage for less money than what you're paying right now. It's that simple. And one of two things happens. Either they find you better coverage for less money and you switch, or they come back and say, hey, we couldn't find anything. Stick with what you got because that's the best you're going to find. Either way, you win. And it costs you nothing to do that. Or maybe you're like an AFR listener named Nick. They were able to increase his coverage by more than $100,000 and saved them $2,000 a year. Save $2,000 a year, increase their coverage by $100,000. By the way, they had been with Liberty Mutual, shocker. 293-0450. 293-0450 for Insurance Network of Louisiana.
2-9-3-0-4-50. Andiamo insieme da me, non c'è.
Call Mr. Electric today for electrical repairs, upgrades, and installations.
Oh, hey, what's up? It's Big V and Bubba, 100.7 The Tiger Morning Show. We'd love for you to join us every weekday, 4 a.m. till 9 a.m.
Yeah, everything you want in a show, country music. We got laughs. We got celebrity in studio guests. We just need you.
Join us every weekday morning, 4 a.m. to 9 a.m., right where it all started.
That's right. Louisiana's country station, 100.7, The Tiger.
$29,995 for a new Ford F-150. Bayou Ford in La Place has brand new 2020 Ford F-150s for only $29,995. All new Bayou Ford vehicles come with a 1,000,000 mile powertrain warranty. And with Bayou to you, free delivery right to your door. The crew at Bayou Ford is going to do right by you.
Gulf Coast Office Products is a nationally recognized Savin office equipment dealer based right here in Louisiana. Over 100 employees strong, Gulf Coast has the boots on the ground to support all vertical markets from education, engineering, legal, and finance. With the latest in office technology from desktop to production segment units, Gulf Coast and Savin have the perfect fit for you. Call 225-756-2644. That's 756-2644 for Gulf Coast Office Products.
Service Mastery Elite create clean, disinfected work environments. As a local business, we take pride in serving the New Orleans and Baton Rouge areas. Our cleaning protocols follow CDC and OSHA standards for healthcare settings, offices, senior living, restaurants, and industrial plants. Contact Service Mastery Elite to get your operation ready for reopening with germ disinfection cleaning. Service Mastery Elite, the trusted choice in professional cleaning since 1996.
Have you been issued a ticket for texting, speeding, or other traffic violations? Have you made a mistake? We all have.
After further review with Matt Moscona, presented by the Aesthetic Medicine and Anti-Aging Clinics of Louisiana, Baton Rouge, Lafayette, and online at theantiagingclinics.com. ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria.
Yeah, I would say I kind of surprised myself. I was going for a low 4-4, but last night I was feeling good about my starts. I felt like I could have got a 4-3 this morning, and I did it. So that was what I was going for.
Jamar Chase. After Pro Day, 4.38 40, 41-inch vertical, and he has basically solidified himself as the top receiver on everybody's draft board at this point. Get to that in just a quick second. Brooks Cabina of The Advocate has a little bit of developing news. Of course, a week ago Friday, there was a Louisiana State Senate committee hearing. Of course, by now, we've talked about that enough. You're familiar. Where Gloria Scott, the 74-year-old former Superdome worker, explained her testimony about an alleged incident with former LSU running back Darius Geis. In that testimony, she alleges that Ed Ogeron is lying about having never spoken to her. Ed Ogeron this week told Off the Bench that he truthfully does not remember speaking to Scott. Well, excuse me, now Ogeron will have the opportunity to speak under oath at the State Senate Committee hearing. This from Brooks Cabina, that April the 8th, so that's a week from today, so next Thursday, Ed Ogeron has been formally requested to testify at a hearing before the Louisiana State Senate Committee after the testimony last week of Gloria Scott, who we just discussed. Several of the members of the Senate Select Committee on Women and Children, which is a bipartisan coalition of female lawmakers, as it said, so neither both Republicans and Democrats, all females on the committee, they've set that date now for their third hearing. And Regina Barrow out of Baton Rouge leads the committee, says that they sent the formal invitation to Ogeron on Wednesday. So Barrow also told The Advocate that Ogeron has not yet responded, and the formal request said that the head coach has until Tuesday to reply. So he is requested to be at the committee hearing on Thursday. He's got until this coming Tuesday to reply whether or not he will be in attendance. I honestly do not know if he is required to attend. I don't know anything of the sort. So, but he has been formally requested. So as that progresses, if there's anything left to say or anything new to say, we'll certainly let you know. But certainly if the LSU head coach is testifying before a committee under oath up at the state capitol. So it's newsworthy, not just for people in sports, but beyond. So we'll let you know as that progresses. On the field, of course, yesterday, LSU had 9 former Tigers participating at Pro Day, and it was a heck of a day. Jamar Chase was the big winner, it would seem, but also Terrace Marshall, who ran 4.38, would seem to have solidified himself as a first-round draft pick. And then a guy like Gracie McMath, who ran a 4.34. Kerry Vincent Jr., who's also a track star, who we knew would run a great time, and opted out of this past season, so it was an opportunity for him to get in front of NFL scouts. Jabril Cox did not work out, but Jacoby Stevens did, and that's another guy who performed very well yesterday for the pro day. And with several of the major college football pro days now having come and gone, we are starting to see new mock drafts with pro days now in the past, in the rearview mirror. And the latest, of course, from Todd McShay of ESPN. And McShay's latest mock draft is a 2-round mock draft. He's got 7 quarterbacks going in the first 2 rounds, which that's kind of what everybody is talking about. Could this be the first time we see the top 5 picks in the draft all be quarterbacks? Well, McShay doesn't think that's the case. But he does have a bevy of quarterbacks going. As you'd expect, Trevor Lawrence going number 1 overall to Jacksonville. Zach Wilson, as many do expect, will go number 2 to the New York Jets. It will be fascinating to see if that happens, what the Jets elect to do with Sam Darnold. After the 49ers traded up to the 3rd overall pick, Todd McShay is projecting Mac Jones, the quarterback out of Alabama, going 3rd overall. To me, that is absolutely mind-boggling that Mac Jones has had this type of meteoric rise. But it's not a quarterback going 4 to Atlanta. Todd McShay has Florida tight end Kyle Pitts going to the Falcons on a team that already has Julio Jones and Calvin Ridley and tons of offensive firepower that is thinking maybe about preparing for its future at quarterback. Trey Lance or Justin Fields would make a lot of sense there, but Todd McShay instead has the Falcons going with Kyle Pitts out of Florida. And then the reunion many are hoping to see, Todd McShay projects Jamar Chase, wide receiver out of LSU, going 5th overall to the Cincinnati Bengals. That would, of course, pair Chase and Burrow or reunite them. Told you yesterday, I would love it for Jamar Chase. I would love it for Joe Burrow if they got to play together again, but I would absolutely hate it if that's the decision that the Cincinnati Bengals make. If a guy like Penei Sewell, who's the best offensive lineman in this draft by anybody's account, a franchise left tackle, if that guy's on the board when the Bengals pick and they decide to go receiver, that's just devastating. Because Joe Burrow, we went through it last year, threw for almost 270 yards a game. His top 2 receivers are back. And I really just want to keep his knees from exploding. So get that dude some protection at 5 overall. Get the best offensive lineman in this draft. If it is Jamar Chase, it would certainly be exciting. But it certainly doesn't feel like that's the pick that the Bengals need to make. What they need to do is protect their franchise. Devontae Smith, 1 pick later to the Miami Dolphins, which means that Devontae Smith would be reunited with Tua, his college quarterback as well. Trey Lance off the board at 7 to Carolina via a trade. And that means that they would, in fact, get their quarterback of the future and move on from Teddy Bridgewater, that Trey Lance would be the guy there. Some other big movers, Patrick Surtain, 9 to Denver, J.C. Horn, 10 to the Dallas Cowboys. The way he worked out, it certainly looks as though he's a guy that's going to be a big mover in this draft. Justin Fields, 11 to New England, according to Todd McShay. That would mean New England would get their quarterback of the future and take him with the 11th overall pick. Of note beyond this, McShay's got Terrace Marshall also going in round 1, number 27 to Baltimore. And this has been a pretty popular spot where we've seen Terrace Marshall, rather, in most mock drafts. The Ravens are a team that need wide receivers. Sammy Watkins hasn't played a full 16-game schedule since 2014, his rookie seasons, and he hasn't broken 700 yards since 2015. So think about getting a dynamic receiver. Terrace Marshall at 27 to Baltimore, someone for Lamar Jackson to throw to would certainly fit the bill. Something that would absolutely make me cringe is if the Saints go wide receiver at 28. But that is exactly what Todd McShay is projecting the New Orleans Saints to do, taking Elijah Moore out of Ole Miss. So I like Elijah Moore a lot. The lifting his leg and pretending to pee in the end zone against Mississippi State a couple of years ago, notwithstanding, as a player, as a prospect, Elijah Moore is pretty exciting. But for the New Orleans Saints, that doesn't make a lick of sense. Just like we've seen some mock drafts that have the Saints going 2-2 Atwell, the wide receiver out of Louisville. The New Orleans Saints lost three defensive linemen. They cut their starting weak side linebacker who tore his Achilles, and they let go their number two cornerback opposite Marshon Lattimore. Every level of your defense, you lost starting players. You have Mike Thomas in a nine-figure contract, and you've also got other dynamic weapons to catch the football, including Alvin Kamara. You're really high on Adam Trautman. And then there are other receivers who have done well for this team. Maybe Deontay Harris makes that step. There, maybe it's little Jordan Humphrey. Maybe it's Marquez Callaway. Maybe Traquan Smith finally takes that big step. Whatever it may be, you got options. What you don't have are starting defensive players. To go receiver at 28 would be nauseating. But it gets even worse for McShay, at least with his projections, because he has the Saints with their second round pick, number 60 overall, taking Alex Leatherwood out of Alabama. Now listen, Alex Leatherwood is a first round talent. He's a really good player and he's versatile. Leatherwood's played both tackle and guard during his time in Tuscaloosa. But you've taken an offensive lineman in the last two drafts in the first round. You also took Ryan Ramczyk in 2017. You re-signed Andres Pete, and you've already got your left, I mean your franchise left tackle in Teron Armstead still under contract. I'll repeat what I said just a moment ago. You lost starting players at every level of your defense. If the Saints use their first two picks to go wide receiver, offensive lineman, I might pull out whatever tiny bit of hair that I don't shave off my head already. Maybe I'll pull out my beard. Maybe that's what I'll do. This Saints team can be very good. They can be a playoff team capable of improving and making a run. They're going to have to hit on starting players in this draft, and it's going to have to be on the defensive side of the ball. If you want to take a flyer in the middle round on a receiver, perfectly fine. If there's a lineman you like who can be a swing guy and a rotational player who may become a starting player in the league one day, great. We saw the Saints use a fourth-round pick on a guy like Jari Evans, a fifth-round pick on Carl Nix, a seventh-round pick on Zach Strieff, all guys who became starters on the Saints' offensive line. I don't doubt at all that they could find great value there as well. But when you're talking about the best players in this draft, the highest draft picks you have in this draft, it's got to be for guys that are going to be immediate starters, and that need is on the defensive side of the ball for the New Orleans Saints, not at receiver or on the offensive line. If you're wondering, McShay in this mock draft does have another LSU player coming off the board in round two. He's got Jabril Cox going 50th overall to the Miami Dolphins. So Cox is a guy who a year ago very well could have been a first-round draft pick had he come out from North Dakota State. Decided to come to LSU, wanted to play at the highest level of college football. And we know as LSU switched from a 3-4 to a 4-3, it caused linebackers like Cox to kind of get caught up in the wash on the interior, and he just wasn't as effective. When he played outside, he became a guy that was just far more effective at covering backs and tight ends coming out of the backfield, making plays in space, had a couple of interceptions. That's what he's going to be in the NFL, and I think Jabril Cox is going to be a much better NFL player. But quite honestly, coming to LSU probably cost him money because he ended up playing out of position. All right, it's after further review. We'll talk about all that with Mike Detillier about 30 minutes from right now. We'll get his thoughts on Pro Day, what, if anything, he learned coming out of LSU's Pro Day. And no doubt we'll talk about what the Saints have done and could still do in free agency before they hit the draft later this month. All right, glad you're aboard with us here. Hope you're having an awesome day here on April Fool's. Yankees and Blue Jays knotted up at 2, bottom 9. Hopefully we get a walk-off. I did that reset there really just for myself because I wanted to see the score. Brain, did you really care about the Yankees Blue Jays bottom 9 over there?
No.
Yeah,
I did not.
Yeah. How are the Mets doing, Brain?
They're COVID postponed today.
Hmm. You hate to see that.
Do you?
No, not really.
I thought so.
Yeah, I'm good. All right, we'll go around the SEC. Stick around.
AFR.
Opening day of baseball. Where else would you watch? Pluckers, are you kidding me? They got every game all season long. MLB TV. Who's your favorite, Brain? Who's your favorite team?
That would be the Mets.
How are they doing today?
COVID postponed today.
Oh, you hate to see it. Well, if the Mets were playing today, you could watch them at Pluckers. Hey, Paulie, who's your favorite team over there, Paul?
That'd be the Atlanta Braves.
Hey, you know where you can watch the Atlanta Braves?
Pluckers.
You can do it. Whoever your favorite team is, all season long, all 162. You need a place to watch, you get by Pluckers. Nicholson or Bluebonnet, let me remind you, tonight, LSU Vanderbilt. That game's on ESPN Plus. If you don't have ESPN Plus, but you want to watch LSU hosting the number one team in the country, get by Pluckers, Nicholson or Bluebonnet. Remember, if you're going to the box, grab a bite to eat before the game at the Nicholson location or after the game, it's at Pluckers. Award-winning jumbo chicken wings, ice-cold draft beer, sports on TV, dine in or carry out of Pluckers if you don't like our wings. We'll give you the bird.
Le posso offrire un caffè.
Le posso offrire un caffè.
Andiamo insieme da me. Non c'è.
Call Mr. Electric today for electrical repairs, upgrades, and installations.
This isn't just another day. It's so much more. Kelly's life was put on hold when her Ochsner primary care doctor discovered a rare blood disorder. Her doctor connected her to an Ochsner care team of cancer, heart, and kidney specialists. With multiple primary care locations around Baton Rouge, same-day appointments, and online scheduling, we're relentless about keeping you healthy. Ochsner Baton Rouge, innovating healthcare for Kelly.
Can you feel it? Spring is almost here, and if you got a new boat for Christmas or you just want to take your boat to a new level, you want front-to-back boat service, HD displays, live sonar that show the fish before you cast, trolling motors. At front-to-back, they got not one, but two NMEA certified techs for all of your marine electronic needs. How does a brand new speaker system sound? Well, guess what? They do that too. So call 225-928-9644 or go to front-to-back boat service.
Acura of Baton Rouge for attractive offers on the MDX.
50 years ago on Easter Sunday, Breck's Baton Rouge Zoo proudly opened our doors, and we've been hopping ever since. 5 decades of connecting people with animals, teaching our community about the problems facing wildlife and how we can help, and working with zoos across the world to protect endangered species. Today, our future is taking flight by stretching the possibilities of what your zoo can become while we keep it fun and affordable for everyone. Thanks for coming along.
It's no secret. The best oysters in Baton Rouge are at Jolie Pearl Oyster Bar. Enjoy mouth-watering South Louisiana flavor and oysters from all over the country. Don't forget our nightly drink specials.
After Further Review with Matt Moscona, presented by the Aesthetic Medicine and Anti-Aging Clinics of Louisiana, Baton Rouge, Lafayette, and online at theantiagingclinics.com. ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria.
I'm glad to have you aboard with us here. Remember, you can always text the show in the 225. It's 396-4400. Yankees and Blue Jays are headed to extra innings. I really, 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 really like to see the Yankees win this game. Got an annual, not that you care about this at all, but just for the sake of putting this out there, every year, my friend Mac Chewilly and I, Mac Chewilly is the founder, CEO of Traction Sports in Baton Rouge. Mac is a fake Cubs fan. And every year, Mac and I have a bourbon bet. So at the beginning of the season, we look at the projected Vegas win totals. You get the difference. And then Yankees, Cubs, whoever wins more games, the loser has to buy the winner a bottle of expensive booze. So I really don't know that I can lose this year. Now, I may lose the bet, but the Cubs' projected win total is 78.5. The Yankees is 95.5. So I have to give him 17 games, which stings a little bit, but the fact that the Cubs are going to be absolute dog poo is actually a little fun because I really, really, really loathe fake Cubs fan on Twitter with his hashtag fly the W and everybody, you know, go Cubs and everything like that. Because you don't really like the Cubs. You only wanted to cheer for them when they win. So anyway, I'm very much looking forward to not hearing from all of you this baseball season. They go to the 10th, tied at 2 there in the Bronx. I will go around the SEC here in just a quick second, brought to you by GMFS Mortgage, GMFSMortgage.com. You will also hear the president of the University of Louisiana system trolling ULL. That's coming up. GMFSMortgage.com, changing lives since 1999. Again, check it out, GMFSMortgage.com. Home buy, refi, construction loans, that's GMFS Mortgage. The low interest rates aren't going to last forever. Make sure you get in touch with a local loan officer from GMFS Mortgage to see if they can help you save money on your monthly mortgage payment. Maybe skip a payment or two. GMFSMortgage.com, GMFS Mortgage. And they are also having their Go Local initiative right now, encouraging you to support local businesses. You can win your share of $10,000 worth of Visa gift cards. Get to the website, find out how you can support local businesses and win. GMFSMortgage.com. Okay, we do it every day about this time. Let's go around the SEC.
Around the SEC, presented by Gulf Coast Office Products, excellence in imaging solutions, the Arkansas Razorbacks.
Arkansas got a commitment from one of the top transfers in college basketball, Pitt standout, Audice Tony. Chose the Hogs over Xavier, Arizona, Cincinnati, Wake Forest, Ole Miss, Georgia, Texas A&M, and others. 6'6", 210-pound wing. He was a three-year starter for the Panthers, averaged 14-6. Tony, a four-star prospect when he came out of high school in Alabama. He was the 117th overall player in the country.
The Mississippi State Bulldogs.
Speaking of basketball, redshirt sophomore guard DJ Stewart announced he's entering the 2021 NBA draft. He will, however, keep open his eligibility with the chance to return. Ranks second on the team with 16 points per game this past season. Iverson Molinar, Tolu Smith also could test the draft waters. Double for the Red Sox, and they're winning 3-2 in the 10th.
Blue Jays.
Habit.
The Georgia Bulldogs.
I hate this season already. Make it go away. Georgia's going to play Louisville in football in like 10 years. Who cares? Whatever.
The Kentucky Wildcats.
Kentucky got a commitment from a four-star kid an offensive lineman named Grant Bingham. He's really big and had some offers from Notre Dame and Michigan and some other people, and said he's going to go to Kentucky and never win anything. There you have it. That is Around the SEC. Presented by Gulf Coast Office Products. If you need office equipment, call Trey Beal and our friends at Gulf Coast Office Products. They're great. Unlike the 10th inning of this baseball game. Whatever. I really need something to cheer me up. Brain, you got anything?
I might have something for you.
Oh, really?
Yes.
What do you have?
I had the president of the UL system on my show this morning.
Mm-hmm.
Want to, you know, talk about how they've managed through COVID, rebuilding McNeese back
real
after
quick,
the storm.
For those that don't know, Brain hosts the morning show on Talk 107.3 FM. For those that are outside of Baton Rouge, that's a news talk station here in town, and he hosts the morning show. So that's the show he's alluding to.
Thank you.
All right, continue.
Yes, so had Dr. Henderson on to talk about a number of real topics, but before we went on air, I was asking him, I'm like, listen, if I ask you about the UL versus ULL thing, is that something you have to shy away from? He's like, oh, no.
Mm.
We can do this.
Okay.
So he had a really big announcement right out of the blocks.
Okay.
So I was like, you know, I don't know if I want to start with COVID or whatever, but you have an announcement. And he said,
you had asked me about the University of Louisiana Lafayette controversy.
Yes.
with Louisiana and whether they could use UL. And I get more complaints about that than anything else. So we're actually changing the name of the university. We are going to call it Flagship University.
And I just that's think big.
And it's really less about the status, and it's just more about the initials.
Think about that for a second. The president of the University of Louisiana system said that they're going to change the name to Flagship University. Not about the status, but about the initials, which, of course, the initials of Flagship University would be, you get it.
To be fair, I cut off right there. The next words out of his mouth were, considering it's April 1st, today would be the good day to make that announcement. So, I don't want to get him in trouble, but that was awesome.
Those ULL people are going to be so triggered.
I mean, Dr. Henderson sat down and I'm like, you don't want this smoke.
Those children in Lafayette. Know your role. Shut your mouth. Daddy just told you to F off. That's so good. All right, we'll wrap up hour number one. Mike Detillier in 17 minutes. Stick around.
AFR.
If you need dinner plans tonight, Ichiban, always a great option. Essen near Perkins. Of course, tomorrow is Good Friday, Friday in Lent. If you're abstaining from meat, Ichiban, great option. The best sushi and best hibachi in the Best of 225 Awards. And from our friends at Ichiban, their newest concept is Boru Ramen, an electric depot on Government Street. Live music, great specials, drink specials for happy hour every single day from 5 until 6:30. It is Boru Ramen. Electric Depot is on Government Street. If you're heading east on Government, away from the river, if you go under I-10, it's just a little ways down on the left. You can't miss the big red brick building there where you have all the different restaurants, different shops there in Electric Depot. And Boru is right in the middle. Of course, the Sweet Things Sweet Shop is there. So if you want to have dinner and dessert, you can do it all there. Indoor, outdoor, patio dining, great courtyard, live music on the weekends. It's Boru Ramen in Electric Depot.
$29,995 for a new Ford F-150. Bayou Ford in La Place has brand new 2024 F-150s for only $29,995. All new Bayou Ford vehicles come with a 1 million mile powertrain warranty and with Bayou to You, free delivery right to your door. The crew at Bayou Ford is going to do right by you.
I've been doing business with Luba for 25 years. They're dependable, trustworthy. It's just the attention to detail with our clients.
Our folks have years and years of experience. They're highly trained professionals, but many companies have that asset. What I'd like to think makes Luba a bit different is that we use those talents in a way that truly is dedicated to serving the needs of the folks who depend on us.
Starting in 1974, Central Plumbing has served Baton Rouge and surrounding areas for all of their plumbing needs. Through these tough and trying times, we want you to remember that the Payne family is here to continue to support and serve you. As a multi-generational business, there is no job that is too big or too small. Residential, commercial, industrial, hospitality, we're here for anything you need. 24/7, 365. Give us a call, 225-925-8552.
Are you a licensed contractor? There's lots of good contractors in Louisiana doing work the right way, but unfortunately, too many unlicensed contractors are working outside the licensing requirements. Working as a contractor in Louisiana requires a license for the company doing the work. The Louisiana State Licensing Board for Contractors wants to help you get licensed to allow you to conduct work legally. It's not difficult to get the license. We can help you. Go to lacontractor.org for more information. Licensed contractors, it's the law.
This is a house call. This is a follow-up appointment. This is a diabetes checkup. This isn't just more convenient care, it's more advanced care. This is innovating healthcare at Louisiana's number one hospital, Ochsner.
I'm Jay Ducote. I grew up learning how to cook at LSU tailgate parties and right in my own backyard. And I created JD's Louisiana products to bring that Louisiana flavor to you at home for your backyard cookout. JD's Louisiana barbecue sauce, Louisiana molasses mustard, spicy and sweet barbecue rub, and more are available at your local supermarkets or by logging on to jdakoti.com/shop. Put in promo code CST for 25% off at checkout.
Have you been arrested for DUI or other traffic violations? Have you made a mistake? We all have. You're not a bad person. Call the law offices of O.C. Brown at 225-343-1111.
After further review with Matt Moscona. Presented by the Aesthetic Medicine and Anti-Aging Clinics of Louisiana, Baton Rouge, Lafayette, and online at theantiagingclinics.com. ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria.
All right, we are inside of 3 hours. First pitch, LSU and Vanderbilt, number one team in all the land. Big opportunity for the Tigers. We'll let you from Tim Corbin coming up here in just a quick second. We're brought to you by the Aesthetic Medicine and Anti-Aging Clinics of Louisiana. Right now, though, Brain has Tigers in the Pros.
Tigers in the Pros. They still bleed purple and gold. They're just really rich now. Presented by Kentucky's Best Hemp. Find them online at kysbesthemp.com.
Opening day Tigers in the Pros. Starting off with the Philadelphia Phillies and Aaron Nola. Nola's 0-for-2 at the plate with a strikeout.
That's not the stat I care about.
Through five innings, he's given up three hits, no runs. He struck out five.
Time for Universal DH. Do it, baseball. Stop being stupid.
Whatever.
I have no interest in watching pitchers strike out.
And he having struck out once.
Having artificially inflated ERAs for pitchers in the National League because they get to go blow fastballs by hapless pitchers five times a game. I had no interest in that.
The ball magically found the bat on the other one. DJ LeMahieu so far is 0-for-4 today and has a walk.
Yeah!
No, sir. Not on that one. Jacoby Jones starts his season off strong. Jones is 1-for-3 with an RBI, ripped a double, and drove in Bieber. I'll just leave that out for any potential Justin Bieber jokes. Alex Bregman will be playing tonight for the Houston Astros. That game first pitch against the Athletics is 9:07 p.m. Central. 9:07.
Is that televised?
You know
they
what?
They all
know.
Are, but
well, yeah.
If it's just a, if it's not a national broadcast, we're not going to get it here.
3 minutes later, the Giants and Mariners will square off, which gives us Kevin Gausman and Jake Fraley.
Atta boy.
Yeah. Riley Smith is on the Diamondbacks opening day roster, but as I'm hitting you're really upset about Riley. As I'm hitting refresh on that game, Madison Bumgarner has not
Aaron
come
Hicks
out of the
struck
games.
Out on three pitches, so, the man on second.
Yeah. Is
do
that blue
you remember,
Jay too much? Is
yes,
that blue too much?
It's terrible.
Yeah.
The Blue Jays uniforms are awful. I was off the plate. It's actually a really good thing. That's awful.
Do I what?
Swing the bat. Strike out on three pitches with a man on second. Moron. I shouldn't call him a moron. He's probably a really nice guy.
Yeah.
I'm just mad at him. Right
it's okay.
Now. Anyway, here comes Mike Stanton.
Okay. Andrew Stevenson is supposed to be getting beat by the Mets today.
Wait, there was something else we talked about.
We're talking about Riley Smith is on the Diamondbacks roster.
Did you even remember Riley Smith at LSU? Isn't that the weirdest thing?
LSU baseball didn't tweet a graphic. I would have never known.
He came here from a JUCO,
mm-hmm.
and I think he played one season in Baton Rouge. And he was like a spot reliever. Didn't really do much, but had a whip and got a no farm system, and I'll be damned, he's pitching in the show now. It's crazy.
Yeah.
Mike
Stevenson.
Stanton's down 0-2. Now, I'm not even calling him Giancarlo. It's Mike.
Mike?
You're always going to be Mike.
Okay.
His name, well, he's Mike for everything. He just up and changed his name to Giancarlo. What, am I supposed to, like, believe
all
you're
sudden,
a Giancarlo? No.
Is this going to go down like Stanton. A Coming to America barbershop scene
like, yeah,
real quick?
Kind of like that.
Mama name him Mike?
Yes.
All right. Stevenson's postponed due to COVID concerns.
Mike just struck out. You get a leadoff double, and then you get your 3 and 4 hole hitters strike out.
See, that's when you have two guys, G and Carlo, put together. Will Harris and Austin Nola were supposed to start the season, but both are hurt right now. Also, 6 points for Naz Reid last night in 15 minutes of play. That would have been a double-double if he'd stayed another year. Reid also had 3 rebounds and an assist, and that's Tigers in the pros.
Nobody got that.
No,
went right over their head.
It's okay.
Brought to you by KYSBestHemp.com. KYSBestHemp.com. Kentucky's best. Come on, Glaber. What are you swinging at? God, so frustrating. Season's 9 innings old, and I'm already annoyed. Kentucky's best hemp. Inflammation, anxiety, trouble sleeping. Kentucky's best hemp is a great option. Use the promo code AFR30, AFR30 to save 30% off your order. All right, Mike Detillier in 8 minutes from right now. Got a full hour of football talk staring you in the face. Tim Corbin met with the media before Vanderbilt made the trek down to Baton Rouge yesterday. And he did talk about, can you play three, please? He did talk about facing this LSU team, a team that's coming off a weekend where they were swept up in Tennessee.
You come up short in 2 walk-off situations. Emotionally, those are tough on a team. But the rebound factor of the team is certainly dangerous, too. And you understand as a coach in this league is you're not scarred by what's happened prior to meeting an opponent. The best team in the SEC is the next one you face, period. That's it. And especially one that's as motivated as this group right now, because they are, and they want to feel success. When they want to feel success and another team's in their way, it's very dangerous for that other team. And we're that other team right now. So hopefully we're good enough to compete and play good baseball.
Don't you hate how nice he is? Don't you hate just how nice and affable and complimentary Tim Corbin is? He's like, I'm going to slug you right in the nose. You're going to bleed, might even break it. Might break your sacrum. But you tried really hard. And I know you really want to do well. It's not going to go well for you. But I'll be darned if that's not one of the hardest faces I'm ever going to have to punch. It's kind of what it feels like. I don't know. I think this is a great, to what he said, in all seriousness. The point he's basically making there is there is a degree of desperation, which is true. You get swept, it doesn't go your way, you want to have success, so you go one of two ways. You either wilt amid the disappointment, or you elevate because you're desperate and you're at home and all those sort of things. So LSU has that going for it in this series. But the reality is, for LSU to win this series, something extraordinary is going to have to happen. LSU is going to have to hit one of the two best pitchers in all of college baseball in Rocker or Leiter. They'll get the chance tonight against Rocker. And look, you could say the whole thing about the law of averages. Eventually it's going to catch up, and maybe there will be that outing where it does. But you know, LSU is going to have to find a way to put the ball in play and not strike out 38 times on the weekend like they did last weekend up in Knoxville, because the challenge is much more sincere this weekend with this staff as opposed to what they faced last weekend. All right, LSU and Vanderbilt, 6:30 first pitch. Tigers host the number one team in the country. All right, Mike Detillier, the number one football analyst in the world. He joins us next on After Further Review after SportsCenter.
AFR.
Brought to you by Relief Windows and ReliefWindows.com. Windows, door, siding, Relief Windows and ReliefWindows.com. But not just windows, door, siding. They're also hiring. I've been telling you about that here of late. And if you want to change your path in life, your career path, if you want to make more money and be happier, if you're maybe in the car right now, driving to a job or from a job that you don't like, maybe this is exactly the message you need to hear right now to make that change. Relief Windows, if you have a great attitude, if you work hard and work well with others, and if you want to achieve success, they want to talk to you, because not only do they have a base salary, not only do they offer you benefits like 401k and health benefits, they also have a bonus structure where if you want to make more, you can make as much as you want to make. This could be that call. So give them a call at Relief Windows, 288-8138 or reliefwindows.com.
I've been doing business with Luba for 25 years. They're dependable, trustworthy. It's just the attention to detail with our clients.
Our folks have years and years of experience. They're highly trained professionals. But many companies have that asset. What I'd like to think makes Luba a bit different is that we use those talents in a way that truly is dedicated to serving the needs of the folks who depend on us.
Oh, hey, what's up? It's Big V and Bubba, 100.7 The Tiger Morning Show. We'd love for you to join us every weekday, 4 a.m. till 9 a.m.
Yeah, everything you want in a show, country music. We got laughs. We got celebrity in-studio guests. We just need you.
Join us every weekday morning, 4 a.m. to 9 a.m., right where it all started.
That's right. Louisiana's country station, 100.7 The Tiger.
Gulf Coast Office Products is a nationally recognized Savin office equipment dealer based right here in Louisiana. Over 100 employees strong, Gulf Coast has the boots on the ground to support all vertical markets from education, engineering, legal, and finance. With the latest in office technology from desktop to production segment units, Gulf Coast and Savin have the perfect fit for you. Call 225-756-2644. That's 756-2644 for Gulf Coast Office Products.
Service Master Elite create clean, disinfected work environments. As a local business, we take pride in serving the New Orleans and Baton Rouge areas. Our cleaning protocols follow CDC and OSHA standards for healthcare settings, offices, senior living, restaurants, and industrial plants. Contact Service Master Elite to get your operation ready for reopening with germ disinfection cleaning. Service Master Elite, the trusted choice in professional cleaning since 1996.
This isn't just another day. It's so much more. Kelly's life was put on hold when her Ochsner primary care doctor discovered a rare blood disorder Her doctor connected her to an Ochsner care team of cancer, heart, and kidney specialists. With multiple primary care locations around Baton Rouge, same-day appointments, and online scheduling, we're relentless about keeping you healthy. Ochsner Baton Rouge, innovating healthcare for Kelly.
Callahan Injury Lawyers.
This is SportsCenter.
I'm Christine Lisi. Major League Baseball's opening day. The Cardinals with a big first inning against the Reds. 6 runs against Luis Castillo. Nolan Arenado has 2 hits, an RBI, and a run scored so far in his St. Louis debut. Cards leading the Reds 7-1 after 2. Pirates up 4-2 on the Cubs, top of the 6th. On ESPN TV, the Dodgers leading the Rockies 1-0 in the top of the 3rd. 2 finals. Miguel Cabrera, first home run of the season amid the snow. Tigers defeated the Indians 3-2. Blue Jays edged the Yankees 3-2 in 10. Longtime North Carolina basketball coach Roy Williams, who led the Tar Heels to 3 national titles, is retiring. His 903 career wins, 4th all-time among D1 coaches. Williams' legacy, about more than that, though, notes ESPN's Seth Greenberg.
All the players that he impacted their lives. His legacy is helping guys become better fathers, better husbands, productive in society. Successful after the ball's taken away. Mm-hmm. Sure, he put a bunch of guys in front. Sure, he's had great success on the court. But to me, if you asked him, it was about the players.
Oklahoma State's Cade Cunningham declared for the NBA draft.
Whether it's offering curbside or next-day delivery for online orders on over 160,000 parts or getting involved in their local communities, when it comes to serving you, Napa's Motor never quits. That's Napa know-how.
Matt Moscona.
I'm very important.
After further review.
Say one more time.
After further review with Matt Moscona.
And here we go.
ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria. Live from the Mercedes-Benz of Baton Rouge Studios.
Let's
After further review, our weekly talk with Mike Detillier is brought to you by the one and only New Orleans original, Sazerac Rye Whiskey.
I'm Mike D, and I get respect.
Why wouldn't I sort of flip the pancake here?
Hour two, off we go. Welcome aboard. Glad you're with us. AFR, presented by the Aesthetic Medicine and Anti-Aging Clinics of Louisiana. I'm Matt.
This is Shaq O'Neal, and I hate Matt.
Paul O'Neal.
They're chanting Paul O'Neal's name.
A brain got a poop. And the one and only Mike Detillier, SaintsReport.com, MikeDetillier.com, the MND Draft Report, which if you have not ordered yet, what are you waiting on? Get to MikeDetillier.com right now. He's with us every Thursday. Mike D, how are you?
I'm doing great. Thank you, Matt.
Mike, before I go any further, draft book, because I always forget to ask, update on it. When will it be done? When will it go out? When can people expect it?
It's a Dunn McCoy.
Dunn! Hell yeah! Ain't okay. No half-stepping here.
Wait a minute now. Let me tap the brake. It's a Dunn McCoy from my standpoint.
Okay,
so we're going to get it back from the printer sometime next week, and as soon as we get it back, probably either Wednesday or Thursday, somewhere in that time frame next week, and then we'll start shipping out.
So still, people can still order online?
Yeah, they can order online, saintsreport.com, mikedetillier.com, and we'll get it out to you.
Did what happened yesterday at LSU's Pro Day alter anything that might have previously been put in that book?
Hell no. ain't nothing there, flip mill page to me. So here's my thing about all that. And it's great to talk about because you have nothing else sometimes this time of year to talk about. If it's a pro day, with no combine, it certainly makes news. And I get it. It gives you something to talk about for a couple of days. But did anything there really surprise you? I'm asking you now.
No.
From a guy who covered LSU, did anything there really surprise you? No, not really. No. Nothing there really shocked you. All these times are almost as though you're training Olympic athletes today, then I see it all across the board. It's not only at LSU, man, it's all over. Some of these times are unbelievable. And they're being clocked by people that are professionals. I mean, you know, you got scouts that are doing this. So it's not like they're green rookies. They understand it. I think for a lot of people, maybe a certain age, they don't like to accept this. But it's true. Young athletes today are bigger and faster and stronger than 15, 20 years ago.
Yep.
Come on, there is no debate about that. It shouldn't be. But I think for a certain group of people, that's hard for them to accept that there are that element is in play. Okay, you can live back in the 80s and 90s all you want, but look at these athletes today, and you just see just how fast they are, how strong, their ability to jump. And they're training for this. It's not like they're training for football. They're training because the same drills have been in place since the combines first started back in the early 80s when we had regional combines. When you know, they had one in Tampa, they had one in New Orleans, they had one in Indy, you had one on the West Coast. John Forcade and I were talking about this. I think John went to like five.
Oh, wow. He participated in five?
And he just sort of followed the group. You know, you went here, you went there. You know, it was regional back then. And finally, it was Al Davis and Gil Brandt, along with sort of presenting this to the commissioner to get him to understand, let's do it under one umbrella, one roofing, where all of us can come and watch it, where you don't have to go, you know, if it's in North Carolina or if it's in Tampa or New Orleans or Indy out in California. Let's do it in one and get it over with instead of all this regional stuff, because now, you know, it's costing us to send these guys all over the place. I think Steve Court had told me he went either to four or five also. But John and I had this conversation, and he was like, man, you know, you were on a trip all over. You know, basically, you go here, you go there, and you just sort of work it. You bring your medicals with you. Now, who would do that today? You know, you got your medical file with you, and you're going from combine to combine. Kind of show, okay, these are the injuries I had. This is what it is. So it's a different world. But the drills haven't changed. And I think if you work at something, you can get a little bit bigger and a little bit faster and jump a little bit higher and lift a little bit more weight. Okay. It's not like I'm taking a 4.75 guy and making him a 4.3 guy.
Right.
Okay. That's impossible. Okay. They got people that want to argue with me about that. And I'm willing to tell them, listen, I've been doing this long enough and I understand it. You don't take that 4.75 guy and make him a 4.3 guy. But if that guy's a 4.41 guy, you know, I can maybe get him to be that 4.3 runner. If he can do 18 reps of 225, I can get him to go to 21 or 22. Because you're training for that, not necessarily football training. It is what it is. And I think the athletes today have a pretty good understanding of it. I really think they do. They understand this is what I'm working at this time. And if you listen to Jamar yesterday, that was one of the things he brought up. You know, I've been training for the workout since November. Okay.
Right.
So he understood what this was all about. And I had no worries about him. Of all the guys, he was the least I had to worry about, because I know how competitive, how focused. Man, you get him out on the football field and get him out on track, no matter what, he is really competitive. And he wants to showcase what he's got, and he got a lot to showcase. Again, it is part of what we're seeing, but not only at LSU. You can go across the country. We saw these, Owa and Micah Parsons, what they ran at Penn State. These aren't little bitty dudes.
Right.
These are guys running, you know, they're in the 240-something pounds, and they ran in the 4.3s, which is shocking to me. Almost like, okay, did they measure the 40 yards, or was it 38? you know, something like that. But, you know, you look at the broad jump, vertical jump, that sort of thing. What it doesn't tell you is the most important thing and why I rarely will change something on a player. It's advice Jim Finks gave me back late 80s. As you would figure, we doing a television show right after the draft, and we waiting on a certain former Saints quarterback to come film his version of it. And I found out that was the precourse to plenty weights. and he turned to me and he said, I'm going to give you some advice. He said, in this world of scouting, remember one thing, fall in love with the player and don't fall in love with the athlete. Make sure it matches. And I think yesterday what you saw was a lot of match. What Terrace Marshall can do on a football field, he measured up to what he could run and do on a track. Jamar, the exact same thing. He could measure up to that. Did anybody not know that Kerry Vincent wasn't a fast player?
Come on, guy ran track.
Guy ran track, and he was a track champion in Texas. Not only ran it, he was a champ. Doing it. So, and Racy, and it popped in my head before all this stuff started to peel out. And this was last year at an August practice. And man, Jamar, August of 2019.
Okay.
Jamar beats a defensive back. And beat him by about 15 yards on a play. Just left him in the dirt with a move, and then he's up the field. And Coach O was there, and we just sort of looked at one another. And I was like, man, that's fast. And he said, let me tell you something. T-Boy, he said, if I had them all on the track, Jamar, Terrace, Justin, Racy, you know who wins? Not by much, but you know who wins? Racy. Hmm. And I'm like, what? He's the biggest dude you got out there, receiver. And he said, don't matter. He's also the fastest in a straight line. And he sure was right about Racy. And, you know, it just, you know, you can see it that, you know, he's got that foot speed that you're looking for. He's a core special teams guy. You understand what he's going to bring you right off the bat. Other than Jacoby, I probably have got more scouts who double-check. That's happening this time of year. You have a scout maybe from the Pac-12, and he's double-checking SEC players. And, you know, I mean, what about Racy? Jacoby's got him beat, and it's a far margin. There's a guy every year that, you know, that kind of circles the track. And Jacoby's one of them that does, but Racy's the number two guy. And I told him, you know, your team picks him right off the bat. He's going to help you on special teams. He is a big-time special teams player. It never really clicked for him as a receiver big time. And he had an opportunity last year, I thought, to really kind of open the door there. And it didn't open up for him like it did for Gage when he was a senior at LSU. But, man, he can play some special teams, and you'll see what else he can bring you as far as a big man, short yardage, red zone type receiver. So nothing really would have changed even if Book wasn't finished.
Mike D's with us. Make sure you order your M&D draft report right now, MikeDetillier.com or at SaintsReport.com. This is After Further Review. Mike's with us every Thursday. Your questions for Mike in about 30 minutes. When we come back, Marcus Williams has signed his franchise tender. Did they get a long-term deal done? And the Saints did add a defensive end. We'll get Mike's thoughts on that when we return. It's AFR.
AFR.
Weekend is almost upon us. Of course, it is Easter weekend. Maybe you'll be having family overs. It means today is a great opportunity to get by with the weather nice to Clegg's Nursery. You want to plant that vegetable garden? You can do it. Vegetable plants or Johnny Naylor's seeds. They've got them, and they are plentiful at all four Clegg's Nursery locations. Also, every day, truckloads of incredible blooming tropical plants. That's at all four Clegg's Nursery locations. Spectacular items to add that beautiful color to your outdoor area. We do it every year, usually around Mother's Day, but this is a great time to go as well. They got a new series of hibiscus with these amazing blooms called the Hollywood hibiscus. They got dippledenias, which is Erica, my wife's favorite. She loves the dippledenias. Anyway, Clegg's Nursery. Four locations in the greater Baton Rouge area. Siegenaer Airline, Denham, Mid-City on Donmore, and the Garden Center on Greenwell Springs. Buy local, shop local, tell them Matt sent you to Clegg's Nursery.
$29,995 for a new Ford F-150. Bayou Ford in La Place has brand new 2020 Ford F-150s for only $29,995. All new Bayou Ford vehicles come with a 1 million-mile powertrain warranty. And with Bayou to You, free delivery right to your door. The crew at Bayou Ford is going to do right by you.
I've been doing business with Luba for 25 years. They're dependable, trustworthy. It's just the attention to detail with our clients.
Our folks have years and years of experience. They're highly trained professionals, but many companies have that asset. What I'd like to think makes Luba a bit different is that we use those talents in a way that truly is dedicated to serving the needs of the folks who depend on us.
During these challenging times, we know your healthcare needs don't stop. Cancer, accidents, injuries, and heart disease are relentless. So we are relentlessly innovating to keep you safe, both virtually and in person, connecting you with providers remotely, advancing clinical spaces, providing rapid and accurate testing, social distancing, and certified cleaning protocols. We are Ochsner, and we will not slow down. Ochsner Health, innovating healthcare.
Can you feel it? Spring is almost here, and if you got a new boat for Christmas or you just want to take your boat to a new level, you want front-to-back boat service, HD displays, live sonar that show the fish before you cast, trolling motors. At front-to-back, they got not one, but two NMEA-certified techs for all of your marine electronic needs. How does a brand-new speaker system sound? Well, guess what? They do that, too. So call 225-928-9644 or go to front-to-back boat service.
Sports wouldn't be the same without the diehard fans. That's why we're highlighting the fans that do the most. 104.5 ESPN Baton Rouge brings you the Citizens Bank Fan of the Week. Check it out at 104.5ESPN.com, the Citizens Bank Fan of the Week.
After Further Review with Matt Moscona, presented by the Aesthetic Medicine and Anti-Aging Clinics of Louisiana, Baton Rouge, Lafayette, and online at theantiagingclinics.com. ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria. Our weekly talk with Mike Detillier is brought to you by the one and only New Orleans original, Sazerac Rye Whiskey.
All right, we roll along with Mike Detillier. Talk a little LSU Pro Day in that first segment. Mike, let's switch gears. Saints had a bit of a busy week. They have signed a defensive end in Tano Passano, and then Marcus Williams signed his franchise tag. Let's start with Williams signing the tag. Mike, do you think there's a chance that Marcus Williams would play this year on the tag and then try to capitalize on a bigger deal? Like, it seems like you are seeing free agents maybe sign shorter deals to be able to get that TV money and the bigger contracts on that next contract. Maybe a possibility for Marcus Williams?
Sign a long-term deal with Marcus. It's remarkable how, you know, and I guess I maybe got to certain places because I listen well. And, man, you got to, because sometimes talking is sometimes an issue with people you work with. So you learn how to listen real well. And when you do these coaches shows, it was to listen if it was Sean Payton, if it was Aaron Glenn at that time, the secondary coach, if it was D.A. Dennis Allen talk. And every time Marcus Williams' name got brought up, how they would sort of lengthen the conversation about him. And, you know, for some guys, you throw a name out there and it's real short. And so you sort of know a little bit that maybe his tenure here won't be real long. But with Marcus, it got extended. And it was always about how smart he is, how he picks things up defensively. Aaron Glenn just sort of went on and on about him. The same thing Coach Payton has, Coach Allen has. And so I think they want him around long-term. And I think they'd like to do a long-term deal with Marcus Allen, Marcus Williams, excuse me. So I think that is evident. They want him to be a core football player on the defensive side of football, which means a long-term deal, which means plenty of money, one way or another. And it certainly helps you. And we know the salary cap now with the new television contract will is going to explode in the next couple years. It'll take a little while to get there, but I think it'll explode, and you'll see that thing come right back way up in the stratosphere. And that way you could take care of guys like Marcus Williams. But they want him around, and they want him long-term. Now, the other part about it is there is much more emphasis on the safety position today than ever before in the NFL because it's a coverage mismatch situation. They're looking for the weak link in the chain somewhere. And for some teams, they feel that the safety position is that. And so that's why I think they want Marcus around. And I think that I wouldn't be surprised draft time if a certain safety was around early, they pick him. Come on, Malcolm Jenkins can't play forever.
Yeah.
Okay. And so you looking at that particular part of the game where you got to match up. And now so many of these safeties, when you do the profiles and you do go back and look, how many of them have played in the slot? They played the nickel corner position. They played out wide. A number of the safeties, especially in this draft class, have played all over the board. And so that's what makes it interesting. But Marcus is going to hit. He's going to win the Powerball, and he's going to win it in New Orleans. They'll give him a long-term contract.
What about Tanno Passano, the defensive end that they signed? How does he fit in on this defense in 2021?
Well, Passano is a guy that, and you want him off the bus first. I mean, you talk about a big dude. He is that. And when he was at the Senior Bowl a few years back, man, he put on a show. Because, again, his size. And there aren't a lot of guys built like him in the NFL. There used to be, but there aren't a lot today. That type size at defensive end. And you can see he's big, he's fast, he's really strong. He is a lengthy guy that you just say, wow, why hasn't he turned it on yet? What's happened there? He's a second-round pick. You knew he was a little bit of a developmental player. Now, he's smart, man. He's one of the sharpest guys around to talk football, to talk anything with you. He is super smart. But it has never really sort of clicked with him as being that early-round pick guy. And so for Tano, it's just – can he put the key in the ignition and turn it and get big-time production? I thought he played better in 2019 than he played in 2020. And what was so funny about that is we doing the Louisiana line camp that in 2019. And Brandon is the defensive line coach. He had just left the Patriots and went to Kansas City. And so I go to do the interview with him, and I ask him about it. You know, I got to ask you about leaving the Patriots to go to Kansas City. He was like, you know, kind of keep it, you know, whatever. But I knew why he left. He was upset that when Flores left to become the head coach, he didn't become the coordinator. Now, Flores didn't have it by name, but he was really the guy kind of running the show. And they passed up Brandon for the job. So his deal was, man, to heck with this. I've been with the Patriots all these years. You know, I'm going to Kansas City. And he was good friends with Spagnuolo, so he went there. We sat down. I said, I'm going to ask you about the big guy. And he said, okay, sure. So I asked him about Tano. And he just sort of, I went back and looked at the tape. He just sort of rolled his eyes back. And he was like, good gracious. I haven't had a lot of guys that look like him that I'm coaching. He said, you know, maybe other guys are that fortunate to have him. But, you know, he said, athletically, he's got everything you want. He's big, he's fast, he's smart, he's strong. But he said, and so he laid it out like that and then sort of stopped. But he said, you know, this game is about leverage. This game is about understanding how to get off a block, read and recognize what's happening in front of you. And that's something we got to work on. In essence, he was telling me, even before he had coached him a game, he knew what the flaws were in Tano. And that he is built like that, but he's never been a big-time player. Now, he did throw in one of the things he's going to help us right off the bat. I put him in the middle on special teams when they kick a field goal, and I want to see that guy try to launch one over him. And he said he's going to help us real quickly there. And I think what you see in Tano is a little bit of up and down play, some inconsistency in that, you know, he'll make a big play here and there, and then you don't see him for a while. But you need somebody, certainly with Hendrickson gone, and it's a great opportunity for him to come in here to see some playing time. And I could kick him inside also in some of these obvious passing situations, kick him inside and let him out-athletic that interior player. But, Matt, when you watch him play, it's the good and the bad with it, too. It's a lot of inconsistent play with him. Great opportunity. But I think the guy that, and this is his chance now to showcase his pass rush skills, is not passing you. It's called Grandison.
Mm-hmm.
Because, again, this was, I think, in October, late or early November, coach's show with Peyton and asked about Grandison, and he started on about he's got his weight right, he's got a chance to be a really good player. And I asked him, you know, which everybody asked me, give a comp, you know, compare him to somebody. He gave a short pause and he said, you know, I was only with him for 1 year and it was at the end of his career. But he said he is built and he's athletic like Richard Dent.
Mm.
And he said, we had him that 1 year in Philly. He said, I was there when I was in Philadelphia with Gruden. And I'm like, man, if he's anything like Richard Dent, I'll take that any day of the week. Because I know, man, you know, you followed football in the 80s, early 90s. Man, Richard Dent was one bad dude out on that football field as a pass rusher. So I hope it works out for him because, again, everything is there for him. He's got all the physical connect the dots. I always, and I'll put this in my draft book, every year about a player that is like that, that physically has it all, but there's something missing. How instinctive he is. Does he have great football instincts? And I think sometimes people say, well, I don't get that. If you're that big, that fast, that strong, you should know what to do. But that's really not the case.
Mm.
You know, sometimes there's some hesitation on exactly what you should do. If you were going to build a safety and a slot guy, would you build him like Tyrann Mathieu?
Nope.
But you want him, don't you?
Yeah, you do.
Yeah, because one thing I can't teach him and he's got is upper-level instincts. And you walk up to Ed Reed, if he's – now, you can see Ed because, man, he got all that gray in his beard now. So, yeah, you know, he's getting to be a pops like me. So, you know, so you can recognize him. But if you didn't know it and you walked up, Ed Reed, you couldn't pick out and say, Ed Reed's a former NFL player and an NFL Hall of Famer. He doesn't look that part, but, man – you could not teach him smarts and instincts football-wise. He just never took a false step. He understood where to get himself in a position to make a play. And that's the thing with passing, you know, that you don't actually see play to play. And sometimes it happens, sometimes it doesn't. But he's a big man, and I do know who ran his individual workout. And it was Ryan Nielsen. Mm. And what was funny, we doing the interview, and Nielsen's sitting like 5 feet away from us, and he's talking about Passanio. Because Ryan was next. I interviewed Brandon, and then Ryan was next. Mm-hmm. And so he did, and so when we finished the interview, Ryan was like, I did his individual workout when he worked out for the scouts. And I said, what are you talking about? He said, Passanio. So it's funny how the two guys that were at the camp, you know, kind of, I'm sure, sort of exchanged some things along the way. But yeah. Ryan's a great coach, but so is Brandon Daly. I mean, Brandon Daly's a really good defensive line coach. So we'll see what happens here. It's a great opportunity for him to be that number three guy, and we all know one thing with Marcus Davenport. He does have downtime.
Yeah.
He just does. I mean, I don't know if it's the way he's built, or he's got that injury list that sort of piles up and something happens. So you need a three and a four. And you've got a three with Grandison. Mm-hmm. And I think he's the guy, Matt, that, man, I look at it from a pass rush standpoint that really could put up some numbers. I sort of think it's Carl.
Okay. Another building block for the Saints. Mike, let me knock out a quick break. We'll come back. We'll talk some LSU spring football up to this point, some observations, and we'll get to your questions for Mike. A little more than 15 or a little less than 15 minutes from right now. Full hour with Mike D, brought to you by Sazerac Rye. Stick around on AFR.
AFR.
Buying or selling a home, you know what to do. Call Darren James, get your home sold. Of course, nobody sells more homes than Darren James, the top producer in EXP Realty in our state for, you know, ever. Agent225.com, agent225.com. That's where you can get all the homes, every home listed by every company all in one place. And, of course, Darren's listings right there, like new on the site today. Millbrook in Baton Rouge, three-bedroom, two-and-a-half-bathroom for $294.9. There's one in Quail Ridge in Slidell for $399.9, a five-bedroom, three-and-a-half-bathroom, 3,400 square feet. Did your listing with a realtor get live radio ad mentions? Let's see if you listed with Darren James, you would. Nobody spends more money to market his properties than Darren James. Nobody works harder to get his properties sold than Darren James. 335-7666, 335-7666. Think real estate, think Darren James.
Think real estate, think Darren James.
Sports wouldn't be the same without the diehard fans. That's why we're highlighting the fans that do the most. 104.5 ESPN Baton Rouge brings you the Citizens Bank Fan of the Week. Check it out at 104.5ESPN.com, the Citizens Bank Fan of the Week.
Fifty years ago on Easter Sunday, Breck's Baton Rouge Zoo proudly opened our doors, and we've been hopping ever since. 5 decades of connecting people with animals, teaching our community about the problems facing wildlife and how we can help, and working with zoos across the world to protect endangered species. Today, our future is taking flight by stretching the possibilities of what your zoo can become while we keep it fun and affordable for everyone. Thanks for coming along.
It's no secret. The best oysters in Baton Rouge are at Jolie Pearl Oyster Bar. Enjoy mouth-watering South Louisiana flavor and oysters from all over the country. And don't forget our nightly drink specials. Jolie Pearl Oyster Bar, located in downtown Baton Rouge.
Starting in 1974, Central Plumbing has served Baton Rouge and surrounding areas for all of their plumbing needs. Through these tough and trying times, we want you to remember that the Payne family is here to continue to support and serve you. As a multi-generational business, there is no job that is too big or too small. Residential, commercial, industrial, hospitality, we're here for anything you need. 24/7, 365, give us a call, 225-925-8552.
Are you a licensed contractor? There's lots of good contractors in Louisiana doing work the right way, but unfortunately, too many unlicensed contractors are working outside the licensing requirements. Working as a contractor in Louisiana requires a license for the company doing the work. The Louisiana State Licensing Board for Contractors wants to help you get licensed to allow you to conduct work legally. It's not difficult to get the license. We can help you. Go to lacontractor.org for more information. Licensed contractors, it's the law.
This is a house call. This is a follow-up appointment. This is a diabetes checkup. This isn't just more convenient care, it's more advanced care. This is innovating healthcare at Louisiana's number one hospital.
After Further Review with Matt Moscona, presented by the Aesthetic Medicine and Anti-Aging Clinics of Louisiana, Baton Rouge, Lafayette, and online at theantiagingclinics.com, ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria. Our weekly talk with Mike Detillier is brought to you by the one and only New Orleans original, Sazerac Rye Whiskey.
Rolling along with Mike D, your questions in about 10 minutes. Did want to get a few thoughts, though, on LSU spring football as the Tigers roll along. And Mike D, when Ed Ogeron met with the media earlier this week, there's two things he said that stood out to me I wanted to get your opinion on. Number one, he said Mason Smith already is the best interior pass rusher they have. That's one. And two is moving Jay Ward to safety. So let me start with the guy who you've been telling me about for, I don't know, 4 years. Mason Smith and the impact he's having in, maybe five or six practices.
Yeah, that really doesn't surprise me much. You know, I got to see him play real early. And one day I'll have to tell the whole story about who tipped me off to that. And it's the most unlikely individual you would ever guess.
Okay.
Because to be honest with you, she wouldn't know if the ball is stuffed or plucked or, you know, all she knew was a big guy. And there's a big guy out here, you know, at Terrebonne High School. And this was when he was a sophomore and just starting his sophomore year. It didn't take me long to spot him, put it to you that way. Cause she had told me he was a senior.
Mm.
Like, okay. And her thing is his last name was Mason. Okay. Well, she got the big part right about the guy.
Right.
but whatever that, you know, watching him, he is an athlete at the highest level for a big man. And I've said this before, he is the best big man athlete I've ever seen from the Bayou. Not the best football player yet, but he's working on it. Because I think Eric Andelsek was. Man, I saw Eric play on both sides of the football. Man, he was special at Thibodeau High School. Now, he wasn't. Eric would have given up eye teeth to have that build. Like what Mason has. But, man, for a big man, he's so quick. He knows how to use his hands real well. He's a good technician for such a young guy, and he's focused. And, man, that doesn't surprise me that he can give you that really good push up the middle. Now, the one thing with him, I think Ed would probably agree, he's going to need a little bit of work on maybe sort of holding his point a little better when they run the football right at him. And come on, you're 18 years old going up against a 22-year-old man. Mm-hmm. That's a difference between an 18-year-old and 22 physically. But as a pass rusher, man, he's going to excel there, and he's going to give you that inside push, which every quarterback I've ever spoke to, when you ask them what's the worst thing you can have, and they tell you, I don't want no pass rush from the middle. I hate it. It takes away my ability to step up in the pocket. And then they got me moving. Either I'm moving backwards or I'm moving laterally. And I don't like either one. You know, I want to sit there and throw it. and that interior pass rush takes it away, and he can give you that real early. And, man, he plays pedal to the metal. And I know there's been a lot of people, oh, my son and my cousin, they beat him one-on-one. And I'm like, what? Beat him in what? Chess? Cards? They ain't beat him on no football field. That's a bunch of horse hockey. But I think it was early, and I think you see it, that he's a special big man and a really smart guy and somebody that that really doesn't surprise me, that he sort of has taken hold of that. And I'm telling you, I'll give you another guy, and he's not there yet, but when Savion from St. James hits that field, they're going to have themselves an edge pass rusher, and I think he can help very quickly there. He's got some skills to rush the quarterback and run the field, and to have both of them here in the Bayou area at one time is amazing. But when Savion's going to hit that campus and he's going to start working, that name's going to be out there. Mm. And Coach Valdez did a good job with him, but, man, you don't have to coach him up a lot. He knows what to do. Jay sort of reminds me a little bit of Kerry Vincent Jr. in that I think that he could play out wide, he could play in the nickel, but also he can play safety. And, you know, Kerry didn't play last year, but he was at that nickel safety, and he played a little bit of high safety. I think Jay Ward is like – now, he doesn't quite have – no, very few people do have Kerry's speed, but he's a little – but certainly a bigger player than Kerry Vincent. And so he brings you that element, and that he has grasped the game from a couple different levels here. And you don't have a lot of depth at the safety position. And I think him at free safety is perfect for him. And also, when you go into dime, I want Jay Ward on the field because of his coverage skills. And so I could see that, and that was a good move by Durante and making sure that he's out there playing that safety position, because now – similar to the Saints, okay, P.J. Williams can play out on the edge. He's played the nickel. But really where he's good at as a dime safety, and that he's got that range that you're looking for in the coverage part of the game. And I look at Jay, he's got some of those same similarities, and he could potentially be the guy as a starter, because he's got some football smarts. He understands it. And the one thing I don't know, and we won't know until a little bit later, is I think at that position, you got to be a chirper. You got to be able to communicate well. How well he can communicate with the other guys and getting them to understand what's happening out on the football field. You know, Ryan Clark was great at it. You know, when Ryan played, he was great at getting other people to understand, because Ryan knew what he could do, but also he knew what you were supposed to do.
Right.
Okay. You got to understand, not everybody knows exactly what they got to do, and things start to change real rapidly. And so you got to have that chirper ability. That's the one thing I want to see with Jay. Is he that type of player? Because if he is, then he's the full Monty. He's exactly what you're looking for back there deep, in that he can communicate really well. And in this game today, you know, with four and five wideouts and the tight end like another receiver, they cutting you off. I was watching film of a small college guy a couple weeks ago, right before my final write-up on him. And I'm talking about he's playing in the MEAC. They doing these pick plays every play they run. Every play, they got a pick somewhere. The guy's coming in, and you know, they're not calling it like they do in, you know, some of the other divisions, but right. Man, they're picking guys off every play. You can see what's happening in this league and understanding and adjusting to that they're setting you up for a big play. And can Jay be that guy to get that, you know, other individual to understand, hey, listen, they're going to try to pick you on this play. Be careful. I've seen it on film. But, you know, Jay's a really good athlete, and the more he's on the field, the better I feel about LSU's secondary.
Certainly know they need some help back at safety. Jay Ward, probably that answer short-term, maybe long-term, right? Mike always has the answers for us, and we got one segment to go. You know the drill. Your questions for Mike D. Tweet me at Matt Moscona, jump in the Bayou Ford YouTube chat, or you can text the show 225. It's 396-4400, 396-4400, 396-4400. Your questions for Mike D to wrap up the hour next.
AFR.
We are into April, and it is a great opportunity to remind you over at the Baton Rouge General Hospital that if you are interested in getting your COVID vaccine, the Baton Rouge General Hospital has the information. They could certainly oblige. Go to brgeneral.org, brgeneral.org, right there on the homepage. Obviously, the thing you'll see front and center, COVID-19 vaccines available. You can get information and how to reserve your shot today. brgeneral.org. If you're interested in the COVID-19 vaccine, you can get all the info, the FAQs for the COVID vaccine. More than 25,000 COVID-19 vaccines have already been given at the Baton Rouge General Hospital. You can get the information or you can schedule your vaccine at brgeneral.org. We're starting to open up. A lot of people are protecting themselves and being safe. COVID-19 vaccine is available at the Baton Rouge General Hospital. Learn more or schedule yours online at brgeneral.org.
Gulf Coast Bank and Trust is giving our customers the power to bank anywhere, anytime during this challenging event. And we're right there with you. Our mobile banking app is a smart way to manage your money and time. Gulf Coast Bank and Trust, the bank that cares about you.
Le posso offrire un caffè?
Le posso offrire un caffè?
Andiamo insieme da me, non c'è.
Call Mr. Electric today for electrical repairs, upgrades, and installations.
$29,995 for a new Ford F-150. Bayou Ford in La Place has brand new 2024 F-150s for only $29,995. All new Bayou Ford vehicles come with a 1 million mile powertrain warranty. And with Bayou to You, free delivery right to your door. The crew at Bayou Ford is going to do right by you.
I'm Jay Ducote. I grew up learning how to cook at LSU tailgate parties and right in my own backyard. And I created JD's Louisiana products to bring that Louisiana flavor to you at home for your backyard cookout. JD's Louisiana barbecue sauce, Louisiana molasses mustard, spicy and sweet barbecue rub, and more are available at your local supermarkets or by logging on to jdacody.com/shop. Put in promo code CST for 25% off at checkout.
I've been doing business with Luba for 25 years. They're dependable, trustworthy. It's just the attention to detail with our clients.
Our folks have years and years of experience. They're highly trained professionals. But many companies have that asset. What I'd like to think makes Luba a bit different is that we use those talents in a way that truly is dedicated to serving the needs of the folks who depend on us.
Gulf Coast Office Products is a nationally recognized Savin office equipment dealer based right here in Louisiana. Over 100 employees strong, Gulf Coast has the boots on the ground to support all vertical markets from education, engineering, legal, and finance. With the latest in office technology from desktop to production segment units, Gulf Coast and Savin have the perfect fit for you. Call 225-756-2644. That's 756-2644 for Gulf Coast Office Products.
Have you been issued a ticket for texting, speeding, or other traffic violations? Have you made a mistake?
After further review with Matt Moscona, presented by the Aesthetic Medicine and Anti-Aging Clinics of Louisiana, Baton Rouge, Lafayette, and online at theantiagingclinics.com. ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria. Our weekly talk with Mike Detillier is brought to you by the one and only New Orleans original, Sazerac Rye Whiskey.
All right, final segment with Mike D. You know the drill. If you haven't done so yet, get your questions in. Tweet me at Matt Moscona, jump in the Bayou Ford YouTube chat, or text me in the 225-396-4400, 396-4400. Chats with Mike D brought to you every week by the one and only New Orleans original Sazerac Rye Whiskey. All right, Mike D, let's get right to it. Austin Burneman via the text line says, ask Mike, who would be better fit for the Saints if available at 28? Jamin Davis, the linebacker, or Caleb Farley, the cornerback?
Okay, give me those names one more time.
Said Davis, the linebacker, or Caleb Farley, the cornerback out of Virginia Tech?
Well, if Caleb Farley's there, I'm picking him. If my medicals... Now, he had a small back procedure. But I would be surprised if Caleb was there. I'd pick him in a heartbeat. 2019, he was terrific. He didn't play last year. He decided to opt out. But, man, he's prototypical what I want in a corner. He's a long, lean guy, and he can run like hell. And he also was a guy, I think, that clocked in after the back surgery, 4.28.
Wow.
Oh. I mean, now my medicals would have to say everything's fine with it. And it was a small procedure, and I've known other guys that have had it. But if he's there, I pick him. No questions.
Steve KGO via text says, please ask Mike about Tyler Shelvin. What do you think about Tyler weighing in at 350, Mike?
I wish it was less.
Yeah.
But, listen, I was glad the first number was a three, and I'm really glad the second number was a five because he's gotten real heavy. When he left here, he was 370s, high 370s. When he left in August. So it means he's lost 20 to 25 pounds. But, you know, on a regular human being, 25 pounds is a lot of weight.
Yeah.
On Tyler, that's not a lot. He's remarkable as an athlete. You watch him in 2019. Okay, he got heavy as the season went along. You saw his shirt sort of expand, you know, because we've all been through that. That shirt starts to poke out a little bit more and more and more. And his jersey was like that. And, man, he was hell on wheels. But I think he'll end up probably being a third-round pick. He's much better playing on the nose. I think that's his spot. But, everything's all hybrid today. But, man, you know, you're concerned about his health. And it's not just short-term, it's long-term with him. So he's a really good football player. I'd love to see what he could do if his second number was a three. Mm. Because that would mean that instead of me playing him like 22 or 23 snaps, I could get it into the 30s with him. And he'd be really, really something special at 300. And that's still big.
Yeah.
But, man, you're talking about 20 more pounds on him. You know, you sort of leaning at the end.
Ask Mike, as Merrick Mathurin. Ask Mike, if Jamar Chase falls to the Bengals, should they pick him?
We will see how much clout Joe Burrow has.
Mm.
Okay, if this was a veteran quarterback, and you know, because when that starts to leak out, that comes from the Joe camp. Hey, listen, I want Jamar.
Right.
If he were a veteran quarterback, I would say that he would go there. Now, here's the two things that are negative. You're dealing with the Bengals. That's one. And that's a long history with that having been real good. And secondly, if Penei Sewell is there, my thing would be to Joe, hey, listen, we need to keep you upright. And Penei can help us do that. And I can get you a receiver in round two, another one. But I need to keep you upright for now 17 games. And Jamar and you are great together. And I understand why you come here and lobby for him. But I'm worried about your health. And that means people up front. Look how badly he was beaten up last year. Before he went down to the knee injury, he was getting hit unbelievable amount of time. So here's my thing. If Penei Sewell is there, man, I'm thinking about his long-term health, and I'll pick him.
I agree with you, by the way. let's see. Ask Mike. We got about 2 minutes left. Ask Mike, where do you have – this is from Cade. Where do you have Kerry Vincent ranked, and would he be a good fit for the Saints?
he'd be a really good fit for the Saints because of his versatility in that he has played out wide. He is better in the nickel slot, and also he's played that dime safety, like we talked about with Jay. And so, yeah, he would be a really good fit. If you don't pick him in the third round, you're not going to get him. I mean, because I think that's sort of where you're going to see him get picked, sort of from the middle of round three into the early part of round four.
Susan Dixon asked Mike, will the Saints re-sign Austin Carr?
I think they will. Now, the problem with Austin is going to be to try to make this team, and he loses his greatest advocate. He lost it.
Drew Brees. Oh, you're right.
That's it.
You're right. Mike, you have nailed that for so long.
Man, listen, every time we talk to Drew, he'd always bring up Austin. And we would sort of look at one another. I get it. But I think they re-sign him. But it's going to be difficult for him to make this team. Really difficult.
SaintsReport.com, MikeDetillier.com, Saints News Network over at SI.com. Of course, the M&D Draft Report. If you haven't gotten yours yet, order it right now at MikeDetillier.com or SaintsReport.com. He's with us every Thursday. Mike D, you're the best. We appreciate you. We'll do it next week.
Thank you, Matt. Hey, listen, if you get a chance, listen to Nick Saban's talk about offensive coaches.
Okay.
Where he refers to them as the Taliban.
Oh.
And basically kind of rips them. A new one.
Send me a link.
It's on my. I just reposted it on Twitter, and he had a conference call.
Mike, I got like 5 seconds till I hit a hard break, but we'll do it. All right, thank you.
Thank you, Matthew.
All right, that's Mike D.
AFR
brought to you by South Point Volkswagen, SouthPointVW.com, new and certified pre-owned in Baton Rouge, and online at SouthPointVW.com. SouthPointVW.com. I've told you before, I drive the Atlas. My wife, Erica, drives the Atlas. We are a Volkswagen family. The Atlas has changed the game. Three-row, seven-seater family SUV. This has redefined the family SUV class because you get the great German engineering without the cost. It is affordable and manufactured right here in the USA at their Tennessee plant. So you're supporting American jobs, you're getting the great German engineering, and you're getting it at a fair price. The Volkswagen Atlas, all the bells and whistles, power everything, panoramic sunroof, safety features. Check it out at SouthPointVW.com. South Point Volkswagen is Louisiana's largest volume Volkswagen dealer. So check them out online at SouthPointVW.com. SouthPointVW.com. South Point Volkswagen. What's your direction?
Have you been issued a ticket for texting, speeding, or other traffic violations? Have you made a mistake? We all have. You're not a bad person. Call the law offices of O.C. Brown at 225-343-1111 or connect with us online at ocbrown.com.
I've been doing business with Luber for 25 years. They're dependable, trustworthy. It's just the attention to detail with our clients.
Our folks have years and years of experience. They're highly trained professionals. But many companies have that asset. What I'd like to think makes Luber a bit different is that we use those talents in a way that truly is dedicated to serving the needs of the folks who depend on us.
Oh, hey, what's up? It's Big V and Bubba, 100.7 The Tiger Morning Show. We'd love for you to join us every weekday, 4 a.m. till 9 a.m.
Yeah, everything you want in a show, country music. We got laughs. We got celebrity in studio guests. We just need you.
Join us every weekday morning, 4 a.m. to 9 a.m., right where it all started.
That's right. Louisiana's country station, 100.7, The Tiger.
Service Master Elite create clean, disinfected work environments. As a local business, we take pride in serving the New Orleans and Baton Rouge areas. Our cleaning protocols follow CDC and OSHA standards for healthcare settings, offices, senior living, restaurants, and industrial plants. Contact Service Master Elite to get your operation ready for reopening with germ disinfection cleaning. Service Master Elite, the trusted choice in professional cleaning since 1996.
This isn't just another day. It's so much more.
Kelly's life was put on hold when her Ochsner primary care doctor discovered a rare blood disorder. Her doctor connected her to an Ochsner care team of cancer, heart, and kidney specialists. With multiple primary care locations around Baton Rouge, same-day appointments, and online scheduling, we're relentless about keeping you healthy. Ochsner Baton Rouge, innovating healthcare for Kelly.
Can you feel it? Spring is almost here, and if you got a new boat for Christmas or you just want to take your boat to a new level, you want front-to-back boat service, HD displays, live sonar that show the fish before you cast, trolling motors. At front-to-back, they got not one, but two NMEA-certified techs for all of your marine electronic needs. How does a brand-new speaker system sound? Well, guess what? They do that, too. So call 225-928-9644 or go to front-to-back boat service.
Sports wouldn't be the same without the diehard fans. That's why we're highlighting the fans that do the most. 104.5 ESPN Baton Rouge brings you the Citizens Bank Fan of the Week. Check it out at 104.5ESPN.com, the Citizens Bank Fan of the Week.
Callahan Injury Lawyers.
This is SportsCenter.
I'm Christine Lisi. Opening day 2021 for Major League Baseball on ESPN TV. Clayton Kershaw on the hill for the Dodgers. He and his LA teammates currently trailing the Rockies 3-2 in the bottom of the fifth inning. Cardinals tag Luis Castillo for six runs in the first. They're leading the Reds 11-4 top five in his St. Louis debut so far. Nolan Arenado, two hits, an RBI, and a run scored. There was some snow on opening day in Detroit. That didn't faze the Tigers' Miguel Cabrera.
Waiting on a 1-1 in a scoreless game. First inning, swinging a high fly ball through the snowflakes and right. Deep, Naylor back to the wall, looking up. And it's gone! A home run! How about it? Miguel Cabrera slides into second because he thought it was a double.
Dan Dickinson on 97 won the ticket, so instead of losing it in the lights, he lost it in the snow. That blast by Miggy was the first home run of 2021. Tigers beat the Indians 3-2. Blue Jays got by the Yankees 3-2 in 10. North Carolina basketball coach Roy Williams retiring after 33 years as a head coach.
What? Just 15 seconds to talk about Twisted Tea Hard Iced Tea? That smooth taste of real brewed iced tea with just the right kick of alcohol? Mmm. What? We started already? Twisted Tea Hard Iced Tea. Look for it in the bright yellow cans. Twisted Tea Brewing Company, Cincinnati, Ohio. Please drink responsibly.
Matt Moscona.
I'm very important.
After further review.
Say one more time.
After further review with Matt Moscona.
And here we go.
ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria. Live from the Mercedes-Benz of Baton Rouge Studios.
That's right.
Three, off we go. Welcome aboard. Glad you're with us. AFR, presented by the Aesthetic Medicine and Anti-Aging Clinics of Louisiana. Matt.
Love you, Matt.
Paul O'Neill.
They're chanting Paul O'Neill's name.
Cade Wazan.
Now, with Aaron Cofield, here's your host, Cade Wazan.
And Mr. Toby Tom Play. We're here. Glad you're as well. It's 5 o'clock. Quitting time. Glad you're driving home with us. Happy April Fools. Happy opening day of Major League Baseball. The OG AFR producer, CV, Cade Wazan, back over there. Brain, on the brain left. I don't know where he went. CV, where? What was the Aaron Cofield, Cade Wazan drop? What was that?
I believe that was... So that first year, you didn't take a vacation. So the next... The first time we took a week, everyone got a day.
Of AFR.
Of AFR. And okay. I believe Aaron hosted and I kind of co-hosted and produced. So I had the voice guy or whoever's the program director at the time. I don't know if it was Dave. Had the voice guy cut like, you know, everybody's name at least so I can kind of slice it into the open. And I believe that was Aaron and I's day.
Okay.
Yeah, interesting. I forgot that I put that in there. I thought I had the Goligan in... And Greenberg one.
Oh, you thought it was going to be the Wazan?
Yeah, because that's the only one I remember. I forgot putting that other one in there.
Told y'all.
Easter egg.
Cade is right. Cade's the OG AFR producer when we started. It's been 11 years ago, CV.
Wow.
We started the show February 17th of 2010 was the first day of AFR. Yeah. It was me and
just
Cade.
After the Super Bowl.
Yeah, right after the Super Bowl, after the Saints beat Indy.
Mm-hmm.
And apparently we did a lot more production back then. We would actually get people, get the voice guy to say the guest host name. And Erin Cofield was, you might remember from Channel 3, from 33, and then she went to Channel 9. And then last I talked to Erin, she's from Connecticut. I think she moved back up, maybe was working in Rhode Island or something, but that's
somewhere where it snows a lot.
Yeah. Somewhere up there in the Northeast, but been a minute since we've heard from old EC, but old Darren Erin, that was a good little Easter egg there from CV.
Yeah.
All right. Glad to have you hanging out with us here. LSU Vanderbilt inside of an hour and a half from first pitch. Once the lineup's posted, we'll run through that real quick. Mike Detillier, on his way out, mentioned this. I just wanted to play it for you. This is what he was talking about. So apparently Nick Saban was speaking to, I don't know if this was the American Coaches Association, it was some clinic that they were doing via Zoom to coaches. And so this video was posted by James Light on Twitter, at James A. Light, who's the offensive coordinator at Warren De La Salle. Is that in Michigan, it looks like? Looks like it's a high school in Michigan. So he's an offensive coordinator at a high school in Michigan. He posted this video of Nick Saban, presumably speaking to the offensive coaches in Michigan. And he mentions the Taliban and Al-Qaeda, which is why I think it caught a lot of attention. But Mike Detillier quote tweeted, here's what Nick Saban had to say.
But let me just say this, all right, because I want to be clear here. All right, all these offensive coaches on here, and I'm sure we got a few. I wish I could look at you when I say this to you. You guys are all part of the Taliban, man. I mean, you're a part of Al-Qaeda. You have changed our game, and made it so hard to play defense for all of us poor defensive guys that, you know, I can't sit in church without shaking my leg or, you know, my hand starts shaking because I'm worried about what you guys are going to do next. So I do respect you, but I still think you're part of the Taliban.
Wow. And thank you to Michael Cobble, who just said that was last week when Saban spoke to the Louisiana Coaches Association. And I wasn't super keen on that because Saban basically used it as a big recruiting pitch to the state of Louisiana. But nonetheless, he referred to offensive coaches as Al-Qaeda and the Taliban. Can we get him fired for that? I mean, I'm not big into cancel culture. But I know there's some things you can't say. Like, you can't say the word Nazi. If you say Nazi, you get fired. I feel like if you say Taliban or Al-Qaeda, you should get fired as well. Now, maybe I'll get fired because I just mentioned those, but not in relation to anything. But Saban called offensive coaches the Taliban and Al-Qaeda, so maybe he should get fired. I just really want his reign of terror to end in Tuscaloosa. That's really all I want. And however it has to come about, I'm with it. All right, glad you're hanging out with us here on AFR. There are two, I'm going to do this quickly. There's two stories that I want to get to that deal with the ever-growing issue of paying student-athletes in college. So bear with me. I'm not going to do this deep dive reset on everything. I think most people understand the state of where things are. Student-athletes want to get paid. Administrators are fighting it. There's NIL stuff. There's lots of controversy. Okay. Well, during the NCAA tournament, some basketball players were wearing shirts that used the hashtag not NCAA property. Mark Emmert met with three college basketball players on Thursday, and they asked him to adopt a temporary blanket waiver to allow student athletes to make money on their name, image, and likeness for next season, the 21-22 school year. Mark Emmert effectively deflected it and didn't come to any real conclusion on it. The NCAA was supposed to vote on NIL legislation in January, postponed that vote, and of course they were at the Supreme Court earlier this week discussing all the NIL stuff, etc. It is of note that Mark Emmert did meet with these student athletes and they're cranking up the pressure here, but I doubt that Emmert's going to make any sweep. It's unlikely that Mark Emmert would make any sweeping decision. He'll wait until Congress makes any type of move. This was interesting, though. part of the NIL legislation, a lot of different NIL bills have been proposed from Congress. And remember, that's what Emmert wants. Emmert wants Congress to pass NIL legislation that covers all of major college athletics instead of having individual states doing it. So Louisiana's law could be different from Florida's law, could be different from Pennsylvania's law, could be different from Ohio's law, could be different from California's law. You get it. Well, back in January, two senators introduced federal legislation called the College Athlete Bill of Rights, and in that proposal, schools would be required to share 50% of their profit with athletes from the revenue-generating sports after accounting for the cost of scholarships. Okay. The Associated Press did a survey of Division I athletic directors, and not surprisingly, but nearly 70% strongly opposed being required to give college athletes a share of revenue. Here's the thing that I would say, proceed with caution from the student-athlete standpoint. You know where I fall. And I'm going over this again because I want to be abundantly clear so you know where I stand. I am 100% on board with NIL. Name, image, and likeness. Let a student-athlete make money off their name, image, and likeness. You want to sell your jersey because you can make money? Do it. You can do appearances and autograph signings to make money? Do it. You can do influencer ads on Instagram? Do it. I'm totally fine with all that. 100% okay with it. A revenue share is just not feasible. I'll give you the example. There were only 25 college athletic departments that made a profit in 2019, the last full year. 25 out of 357 in Division I, only 25 made a profit. Let's take LSU, which was 10th in revenue, okay? LSU generated $157 million in revenue. I'm not going to confuse you, but I'll do my best to make this simple. So keep in mind, with that bill, after the scholarship money is accounted for, the athletic department will be required to share 50% of the revenue with their student athletes. So for LSU, $157 million in revenue, roughly half of the expenses are scholarships. So let's say there's $75 million after scholarships. This bill says LSU would have to split that $75 million 50-50 with its student athletes, which means LSU would have to fund its entire athletic department on roughly $37 million. Sounds like a big number. Football's annual budget's around $30 million. Men's basketball is $6 million. Baseball's $5 million. That puts you at $41 million. You don't even have enough money to fund football, men's basketball, and baseball with this bill. At a place like LSU where you generate $157 million, you could not even afford to fully fund those three sports which make you money. If you're okay with every other college sport going away, then this is your plan. I'm here to tell you, that ain't feasible. Throw it in the trash. The best method for the NCAA, the fairest method, is let the student athletes make money on their name, image, and likeness. Blanketly. Do that, and that solves your issue. All right, it's after further review. We're brought to you by Hudco Roofing, HudcoRoofing.com. HudcoRoofing.com. Love to tell you over at Hudco, me and my partners at Hudco, we say it every day, do business with someone you know. And like, go to the homepage at HudcoRoofing.com. You see a picture of Ryan Terrio, you see a picture of me. We're partners in Hudco with amazing people. Jeff Hudson and his wife Sherry started Hudco 20 years ago up in the Shreveport-Bossier area. Our partner Richard Tilley runs the operation here in South Louisiana, but no matter where you are in the state, our Shreveport office, everything Alexandria North, call the Shreveport office. If you're anywhere along the I-10 corridor, call us. We'd love to come out and do a free roof inspection. That's how the process starts. We'll get up on your roof. We'll do a full inspection, pictures, description, all of it to help you submit that to your insurance company so we can work with your insurance company to get your claim approved, get you a new roof. All you pay is your deductible. HudcoRoofing.com. If nothing else, just go to the website so you can see the picture of me and Terrio. HudcoRoofing.com. HudcoRoofing.com. Do business with someone you know. HudcoRoofing.com. All right, it's after further review. Waiting on the lineup to be posted for LSU and Vanderbilt. Game one of that series is getting underway in about an hour and 17 minutes from right now. When the lineup's posted, we'll run through it. We do expect that Collier Cranford will be at second base and Will Safford will be in center field. But when that game, or when the lineup is posted, rather, we'll run through it and let you know our thoughts as game one gets underway tonight with Kumar Rocker against Landon Marceau. There will be radar guns and scouts aplenty in attendance tonight and all weekend at the box. All right, it's after further review. If you want to join us, you can tweet the show at Matt Moscona, jump at the Bayou Forward YouTube chat on the Watch 104.5 ESPN YouTube channel, or you can always text us in the 225. It's 396-4400, 396-4400. Let me knock out a quick break. We'll continue on AFR.
AFR.
Well, we're getting a little bit of a cold snap, and that always seems to happen this time of year. There's always one more. But you know that 100 degree temps are right around the corner. And your home central AC is going to be churning and working overtime every single day. So, before we get into triple digit temps, before you tax your home central AC, make sure it is prepared to handle that burden. River City's 1 hour air. River City's 1 hour air. You'll see the big yellow vans and trucks with the giant clock on the side all over town because so many friends and neighbors do what I do. They trust River City's 1 hour air. Preseason AC tune-up, just $97. That's $30 off the price just for listening to AFR. Preseason AC tune-up from River City's 1 hour air. Give them a buzz. 752-0001. 752-0001, where they're always on time or you don't pay a dime.
It's no secret. The best oysters in Baton Rouge are at Jolie Pearl Oyster Bar. Enjoy mouth-watering South Louisiana flavor and oysters from all over the country. And don't forget our nightly drink specials. Jolie Pearl Oyster Bar, located in downtown Baton Rouge.
Gulf Coast Bank and Trust is giving our customers the power to bank anywhere, anytime during this challenging event. And we're right there with you. Our mobile banking app is a smart way to manage your money and time. Gulf Coast Bank and Trust, the bank that cares about you.
At All-Star Toyota, you get it all. If you're in the market for an all-new Toyota vehicle, come see our friendly and knowledgeable sales team at All-Star Toyota. Located in Baton Rouge at the corner of Airline and Goodwood, we've been serving our community since 2005 by offering a large selection of new Toyota cars, trucks, and SUVs. Get behind the wheel of your dream car and take a test drive at All-Star Toyota today.
50 years ago on Easter Sunday, Breck's Baton Rouge Zoo proudly opened our doors, and we've been hopping ever since. 5 decades of connecting people with animals, teaching our community about the problems facing wildlife and how we can help, and working with zoos across the world to protect endangered species. Today, our future is taking flight by stretching the possibilities of what your zoo can become while we keep it fun and affordable for everyone. Thanks for coming along.
Have you been arrested for DUI or other traffic violations? Have you made a mistake? We all have. You're not a bad person. Call the law offices of O.C. Brown at 225-343-1111 or connect with us online at ocbrown.com.
Thank you.
Acura of Baton Rouge for attractive offers on the MDX.
After Further Review with Matt Moscona, presented by the Aesthetic Medicine and Anti-Aging Clinics of Louisiana, Baton Rouge, Lafayette, and online at theantiagingclinics.com. ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria.
So yesterday, actually it was Tuesday, our friend Todd Graffanini was here, radio voice of the Pels, and he finished the interview with us by saying, we're hoping for a better result, because he and I candidly have had this sort of off the record banter. It seems though every time that he comes on the show, the next time the Pelicans play, they suck. The last time the Pels got blown out by the Bulls, last time Graf was on. So he came here Tuesday, was on the show. Of course, the Pels have just beaten Boston. They've winners of 4 or 5. We're feeling pretty good. And they're coming home. They're playing Orlando. They get a couple of days off. Surely this is going to go well for New Orleans. Feeling good. 2 days rest. Orlando's got to travel. This is going to go well for the Pels. Well, the Pels tonight are going to play the Orlando Magic, but they are going to play the Orlando Magic without Zion Williamson. And without Lonzo Ball. And very likely without Brandon Ingram. So, I think it is official that Todd Graffanini is a curse. CB, can we get a ruling on this? Can we just go ahead and call Graff a curse? He's like Marie Laveau. He's the Superdome that was built on an old voodoo graveyard, and that's why the Saints sucked for 40 years. That's why the Pels are never going to win, because of Graf.
Has it happened more than 3 times?
Why?
Because I think that's the number, right?
Rule of threes?
Yeah.
What do you mean?
I don't know. I think if it happens at least 3,
like Beetlejuice?
It's a trend.
Like you say Beetlejuice 3 times, he appears?
Kind of, yeah.
Well, Zion sprained his right thumb. Lonzo Ball has a hip flexor strain. They're out. And then Brandon Ingram has right first MTP irritation. And he's listed as doubtful. What is MTP irritation? Can you look that up for me and let me know? Metatarsal? Do I sound smart if I say the word metatarsal? I don't know what MTP is, but apparently Brandon Ingram has slight MTP irritation and he's doubtful for tonight. Graf, it's your fault, by the way, and you can never come on AFR ever again. All right, so the Pels are going to play Orlando tonight, but they're going to be without Zion, without Lonzo, and very likely without B.I., so don't expect much. Thank you. MTP, it's your big toe. What do you got, CV?
There's a big word that starts with an M that starts this thing, and I'm not going to try, but it's a joint pain. Yeah.
Okay.
Toe and foot pain.
Well, right? a very good source, who I don't know if this source would want me to say his name, just texted me and said big toe. And trust me when I tell you, this person knows what that would be. So I won't mention this person's name, but this person let me know that it's the big toe.
I tripped over a Lego block in the living room for my
it's
daughter
the worst.
On the big toe. And it's been about a month or two, and it's still not right.
CB, Legos.
Small toys.
What's going on with the Legos?
We even got it's the big blocks. It's not Lego brand. It's the big ones that the kids are, I guess, a little easier for the younger ones to use.
Big block sing song.
Yeah, so still hurts.
Does Annabelle watch Big Block Sing Song?
No.
Okay.
I have things that.
It's not bad. If you're looking for like kids stuff that they might enjoy that isn't terrible for adults to listen to, Big Block Sing Song, give it a go.
Cool.
So Pels are likely going to lose tonight, and we have Todd Graffanini to blame for that. The other thing that I want to delve into, I'm waiting on this LSU lineup to be posted. When it is, we'll let you know. But Tim Corbin, head coach at Vanderbilt, was asked about this 1-2 punch that he has right now with Kumar Racker and Jack Leiter that LSU is going to get to see firsthand this weekend there at Alec Box Stadium. And considering the amount of talent, first-round talent, guys like David Price on through as a first overall pick on through that they've had come through that Vanderbilt program, how does this 1-2 punch compare?
They're both so unique. We haven't had someone like Kumar. We haven't had anyone like Jack. They're cut out of a different cloth, but there's some likeness too, Chris, from standpoint of, you know, there's a personality trait with Kumar that's similar to, you know, David Price. He has fun. He's very vocal when he's not pitching. And Jack's just a very flatline. He's got a good personality, but he's more internal than anything. And I'd say, you know, kind of not to compare the two, but Mikey Minor was that way a little bit. But I think their physical skill sets are, you know, just unique and different, which makes what made Carson different, which made Walker different. They're really, I couldn't really compare them to anyone that way, and which is good. I like the fact that they're different.
Mm. It is bonkers to listen to him roll through Carson Fulmer and Walker Buehler and David Price and Mike Minor and Sonny Gray. The amount of Tyler Beatty, my God, the amount of aces they've had roll through that program is a mouthful. It's impressive. And when you look at these two guys, this very likely is the best 1-2 that they've had at Vanderbilt. So huge task for LSU tonight, but that also creates a huge opportunity. We'll see if they can get going against Kumar Rocker, who's got a sub-1 ERA and isn't even the best pitcher on his team right now. One other thing I want to get to real quick. The NFL's competition committee has endorsed 6 potential rule changes for this coming football season. One of them is something that I'm excited to see, because if you listen to this show and have for any amount of time, you know that I want robots. And eventually, the robots are going to take over the world and kill us all, but until, and it'll be our own undoing. But until then, let's use the robots to our benefit. We have robots. We have technology. Damn it, let's use it. Let's stop blowing calls on the field. Let's use the technology we have to take a common sense approach to how we can better officiate games, to do it in a quicker fashion, and to get calls right. I don't need stoppages in the game, running over, going under the hood, putting on headsets, looking at the iPad or the Surface, the Microsoft Surface, real close and stopping the game. There's a better way to do it. You got a guy in the booth? Let him radio down to the guy on the field and get the call right. No problem. Well, that is, in my opinion, an inevitability that we are going to get there. And we're already seeing it in the use of technology in so many sports. The NFL is taking another step. They're taking baby steps, as if the Nola no call wasn't the impetus for what should have happened immediately to make sure that never happens again. At least we're taking steps toward it. And what the NFL Competition Committee has endorsed, this has to be voted on by the owners, and 24 of the 32 owners have to vote yay to approve it, but it's been endorsed by the Competition Committee. This would allow, it's not an eighth official in the booth. This isn't the sky judge, what we've talked about, but it's a step toward it. If video available in the press box shows, as it stated, clear and obvious evidence, the replay officials in the booth can advise the officials on the field on possession, a completed or intercepted pass, whether a player is down by contact, and position of the ball relative to the line or boundary. So where do they go out of bounds? Coaches can still initiate formal review on these plays, but now the replay official in the booth can buzz down and say, hey, you got that wrong. It was an incomplete pass. Boom. Done. Incomplete. Move on. It makes so much sense. You don't need to be having coaches dig into their sock for a red flag to throw on the field to have the overweight official waddle over to explain what he wants him to review, to then blow the whistle and do the big T for a TV timeout, and then to run to the sideline to go see the Microsoft Surface and stare at a little 12-inch screen to see if they can determine if he's in or out, and then come back from commercial break, make the announcement, and then carry on. Instead, how about,
hey, Steve, yeah, I know it was close, man, but that was an incomplete pass.
Incomplete pass. All right, third down. Move on with our lives. It's simpler. It's foolproof. It's fail-proof. It makes so much sense. It's another step towards Sky Judge, which is an inevitability. It will happen in our lifetimes. It will happen in this decade, and this is another step toward it. So the competition committee has endorsed it. Let's make sure the owners don't get stupid and approve it. All right, it's after further review. Thursday show is brought to you by the Aesthetic Medicine and Anti Aging Clinics of Louisiana. Baton Rouge, Lafayette, and online at theantiagingclinics.com. Okay, y'all, let me knock out a quick break. When we come back, two things I want to talk about. One, I'll update you if you haven't heard yet. Ed Ogeron has been summoned by that Louisiana State Senate committee. We'll get you an update on that. And waiting on this lineup to be posted for LSU and Vanderbilt. When it is, we will discuss LSU's 1-9. They're starting 9 tonight as they take on the number one team in the country. Glad you're hanging out with us here. Stick around. It's AFR.
AFR.
Had a great morning chatting with my buddy Shane Danton over at Pinnacle Exterior Construction. Shane and his landscape architect came out to our house. I told you at the Casa de Scone, we have a pool, but we've been wanting for a long time to upgrade our outdoor space. I've always wanted to add an outdoor kitchen, you know, our grill, little bar top. So called Pinnacle Exterior Construction. Shane came out, brought his landscape architect. We look at our outdoor space. They sketch some stuff out. Then their graphic designer gets a computer-generated image of it so that we can look at what it would actually look like and then make changes. The whole process is fun. It's easy. It's low pressure. And the work they do is gorgeous. Y'all, check out their website, pecbuilt.com. It's Pinnacle Exterior Construction. pecbuilt.com. You'll see that pinnacle green. If it's pools, outdoor kitchens, fences, decks, bulkheads, Pinnacle Exterior Construction. They got free consultations. pecbuilt.com.
$29,995 for a new Ford F-150. Bayou Ford in La Place has brand new 2020 Ford F-150s for only $29,995. All new Bayou Ford vehicles come with a 1 million mile powertrain warranty. And with Bayou to You, free delivery right to your door. The crew at Bayou Ford is going to do right by you.
Starting in 1974, Central Plumbing has served Baton Rouge and surrounding areas for all of their plumbing needs. Through these tough and trying times, we want you to remember that the Payne family is here to continue to support and serve you. As a multi-generational business, there is no job that is too big or too small. Residential, commercial, industrial, hospitality, we're here for anything you need. 24/7, 365, give us a call, 225-925-8552.
Are you a licensed contractor? There's lots of good contractors in Louisiana doing work the right way, but unfortunately, too many unlicensed contractors are working outside the licensing requirements. Working as a contractor in Louisiana requires a license for the company doing the work. The Louisiana State Licensing Board for Contractors wants to help you get licensed to allow you to conduct work legally. It's not difficult to get the license. We can help you. Go to lacontractor.org for more information. Licensed contractors, it's the law.
This is a house call. This is a follow-up appointment. This is a diabetes checkup. This isn't just more convenient care, it's more advanced care. This is innovating healthcare at Louisiana's number one hospital, Ochsner.
I'm Jay Ducote. I grew up learning how to cook at LSU tailgate parties and right in my own backyard. And I created JD's Louisiana products to bring that Louisiana flavor to you at home for your backyard cookout. JD's Louisiana barbecue sauce, Louisiana molasses mustard, spicy and sweet barbecue rub, and more are available at your local supermarkets or by logging on to jdecody.com/shop. Put in promo code CST for 25% off at checkout.
I've been doing business with Luba for 25 years. They're dependable, trustworthy. It's just the attention to detail with our clients.
Our folks have years and years of experience. They're highly trained professionals. But many companies have that asset. What I'd like to think makes Luba a bit different is that we use those talents in a way that truly is dedicated to serving the needs of the folks who depend on us.
Le posso offrire un caffè?
Le posso offrire un caffè?
Andiamo insieme da me, non c'è.
After Further Review with Matt Moscona, presented by the Aesthetic Medicine and Anti-Aging Clinics of Louisiana, Baton Rouge, Lafayette, and online at theantiagingclinics.com. ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria.
All right, Jimmy Ott joins us in about 12 minutes from right now. We'll do Otter Locks and what we learned. We're heading into the Easter weekend. A lot of you may have the day off tomorrow. We will be here tomorrow. LSU Vanderbilt tonight in baseball. Tomorrow, of course, Riot Radio Hours. We will recap game one, get you set for the weekend. And just as a random aside, I do like what the SEC has done for years during Easter weekend. They would play a normal weekend, a Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Several years ago, the SEC did this so that teams could have off on Easter Sunday, so everybody in the league plays Thursday, Friday, Saturday on Easter weekend. So a good thing, I think, that the SEC has done. It kind of gives everyone their opportunity to be with family and to celebrate the holiday. So great thing there by the SEC. And LSU gets Vanderbilt tonight. And we'll be back tomorrow. So be sure to join us wherever you are. If you're at home, if you're off of work, driving around, running some errands, whatever it may be, we'll be here tomorrow. And hope you'll join us then. On Thursday, a week from today, Ed Ogeron could very well be up at the Louisiana State Capitol. So a week ago, Friday, so 6 days ago, there was a hearing at the Louisiana State Senate, the Select Committee on Women and Children. It's a committee made up of female lawmakers. Well, they heard the testimony of Gloria Scott, who's the 74-year-old woman, former Superdome employee, who gave her testimony about her alleged encounter with Darius Geis back in 2017. And she said under oath that Ed Ogeron is lying about never having spoken to her. Ed Ogeron adamantly denied that this week in his interview with Hester and T-Bob, where he said, "I truthfully do not remember speaking to Ms. Scott back in 2017. So Coach O has now been summoned. He has been requested, formally requested, to testify on April the 8th. So that's a week from today. LSU was on the practice field today, and they have typically carried the Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday practice schedule throughout spring. But Ed Ogeron has been requested formally to be at that committee hearing a week from today up at the Louisiana State Capitol. You don't need me to rehash everything that's been said. I don't know that there's much more to say right now other than a week from today, if in fact Ed Ogeron does appear at the State Capitol, and he has until Tuesday to respond to that formal request, that it's certainly going to be something you got to pay attention to. When the head coach of LSU is going to be testifying under oath at the Louisiana State Capitol before a Senate committee, that's certainly of great interest and great note, and we will be paying attention a week from now if, in fact, Ed Ogeron does appear. And again, I quite honestly just don't know the legalities. I don't know if he's required to go or if he can decline, but they have requested him to appear and testify next week, a week from today, at that Louisiana State Senate hearing. It's after Further Review. If you want to join us, you can tweet the show at Matt Moscona, at 104.5 ESPN. You can jump at the Bayou Ford YouTube chat on the Watch 104.5 ESPN YouTube channel, or you can always text the show in the 225. It's 396-4400, 396-4400, 396-4400. 4400. Save that number in your phone. Text me anytime. And a lot of you do when LSU plays baseball, especially when things aren't going well. I am very interested to see how this series is going to go for LSU. It's a great bounce-back opportunity after a disappointing weekend up in Knoxville. And like we talked about, yes, LSU got swept. They also went into extra innings twice on the road against the top 10 team in America. I would feel very differently about last weekend had LSU gone and lost 8-1, 12-3, and 6-0. Losing 3-1 when you out-hit Tennessee and then losing twice in extra innings means you were right there. You just didn't make enough winning plays. So this isn't a great opportunity, a great team that you want to get right against with Vanderbilt coming in, but it's still a great opportunity for LSU, and the lineup is now posted. So let's run through this. We are 50 minutes away, thereabouts, from first pitch with LSU and Vanderbilt. Trey Morgan is going to stay in that leadoff spot. Will Safford, as Paul Maneri mentioned, will bat second and play center field, and then Dylan Cruz will bat third and play in right field. So Morgan, Safford, Cruz. I like that lineup a lot. Trey Morgan's on-base percentage all year has been amazing, even when he hasn't hit like the other night. He walked three times. Will Safford is a guy who we here have talked about an awful lot. He was penciled in as the starting third baseman before the season started. Had some trouble making the throw from third. Went to the bench. Maneri had a rotating door around the infield. Safford kind of got lost in the shuffle. But this is a guy who has, he's kind of a dirtbag, man. He's a grinder, a guy you want on the team. And look, if you're going to, hit second, usually you're going to see a lot of fastballs. So maybe this is an opportunity for Will Safford maybe to be a catalyst in this offense. And then we talked, of course, about Dylan Cruz. His approach batting first or third hasn't changed. The difference is he's obviously hitting now with guys on base batting third, which was the ideal situation for him all season long to be in the run-producing spot in the order. So Morgan, Safford, Cruz. Gavin Duga, bat cleanup and play in left field. Kay Doty, bat fifth and play third base. And then Beloso remains your DH, batting sixth. Maneri's been really committed to getting Cade Beloso going. He homered the other night, and that is a guy that you really need to get going and a guy that has shown he can hit at this level. The other thing that we've talked about, I know Todd Walker shared this with us when he was here a couple of, last week, was always look at the strikeout-to-walk ratio. And, Beloso is a guy that's only struck out a handful of times all season. He's putting the ball in play. He just needs to have some good baseball fortune where he's hitting the ball where the defenders aren't, and hopefully that comes along. So, Morgan, Safford, Cruz, Duga, Doty, Beloso. Jordan Thompson will bat seventh and play short. Collier Cranford, as expected, will bat eighth and play second base. And then Alex Milazzo is going to catch and bat ninth. I would really like to see maybe Cranford seventh, Milazzo eighth, and Thompson ninth. I just want some offense in that nine hole when you turn the lineup over. But I wouldn't expect to get a lot out of the bottom of the order. I'm not sure I expect to get a lot anywhere in the order against this Vandy starting, this Vandy pitching with Rocker going tonight and with Leiter going tomorrow. But Palmieri said he wanted to go more defensive minded. Really, I would say Cranford at second is the only one there because Safford in center can make some plays for you. But Safford's a bat that I think you need in the lineup every day. Everything else there, 1-7, gives you the opportunity at offense. Cranford batting eighth, Milazzo batting ninth. That's, you're not expecting much offensively from those guys, but if they could maybe just be productive and move runners or however it may be, that's probably what you're maximizing those guys in the 8-9 hole offensively tonight if you can. So, all right, starting nine has been posted for LSU, and it'll be Landon Marceau on the bump. This is always kind of one of those fun nights where you're going to look behind home plate, and you're going to see a ton of radar guns. There will be scouts galore at the box tonight and really all weekend with a guy like Marceau, who was a seven-figure signing bonus guy coming out of high school when he passed on the money. Rocker, who may very well be the first overall pick. Tomorrow, of course, with Jaden Hill and Jack Leiter, a couple of guys who are very likely both going to be top 10 picks in this summer's draft. And then you throw in a guy like Dylan Cruz. Talent all over the field here with LSU and Vanderbilt tonight. Hopefully we're treated to a really competitive series and hopefully an LSU series win. Got a lot of work to do to get it. And they'd have to do something nobody's been able to do, which is win a series against Vanderbilt this year. But counting down, almost here. Okay, it's After Further Review, brought to you by the Aesthetic Medicine Anti-Aging Clinics of Louisiana. Let me take 60 seconds and remind you about Michelli Weighing and Measurement. Check them out at Michelli.com, Michelli.com, Michelli.com. Some people have asked, hey, Matt, can you explain the ISO 17025 accreditation thing? No, candidly, because realistically, if you're a company that knows what ISO 17025 accreditation is and why it's so important, then Michelli is for you. If you don't, then chances are the products and services they offer don't really apply. But the way that I could explain it most plainly, of all the industries that they service, if it's aerospace or aggregates, if it's agriculture, if it's food and beverage, any of those industries, if you weigh or measure something, transportation, manufacturing, energy, chemical and petrochemical industries, if you weigh or measure something, they sell, rent, or service the products that you use to weigh and measure things. Michelli's, they're right there in Harahan. Been there since 1947. And they are the largest distributor of scales in the country, Louisiana business. Such an awesome story, man. And I'll tell you what's really cool about them as well. They love to do business face-to-face. When you walk into their building, the first door on the left, that's Joel McMullen. That's his office. He's the president and CEO of the company. His office is the first one on the left, and the door is always open. Like, it's just such a cool vibe that they have and the way that they do business. Michelli.com, 29 offices in 11 different states. They're a great big company that operates like a family-owned business, because they are, and it's awesome. Michelli.com, check them out. Michelli.com, Michelli.com. All right, it's After Further Review. We'll wrap up with Otter Locks when we come back on AFR.
AFR.
At All-Star Toyota, you get it all. If you're in the market for an all-new Toyota vehicle, come see our friendly and knowledgeable sales team at All-Star Toyota. Located in Baton Rouge at the corner of Airline and Goodwood, we've been serving our community since 2005 by offering a large selection of new Toyota cars, trucks, and SUVs. Get behind the wheel of your dream car and take a test drive at All-Star Toyota today.
Oh, hey, what's up? It's Big V and Bubba, 100.7 The Tiger Morning Show. We'd love for you to join us every weekday, 4 a.m. till 9 a.m.
Yeah, everything you want in a show, country music. We got laughs. We got celebrity in studio guests. We just need you.
Join us every weekday morning, 4 a.m. to 9 a.m., right where it all started.
That's right. Louisiana's country station, 100.7 The Tiger.
Le posso offrire un caffè?
Le posso offrire un caffè?
Andiamo insieme da me, non c'è.
Call Mr. Electric today for electrical repairs, upgrades, and installations.
Have you been arrested for DUI or other traffic violations? Have you made a mistake? We all have. You're not a bad person. Call the law offices of O.C. Brown at 225-343-1111 or connect with us online at ocbrown.com.
Gulf Coast Office Products is a nationally recognized Savin office equipment dealer based right here in Louisiana. Over 100 employees strong, Gulf Coast has the boots on the ground to support all vertical markets from education, engineering, legal, and finance. With the latest in office technology from desktop to production segment units, Gulf Coast and Savin have the perfect fit for you. Call 225-756-2644. That's 756-2644 for Gulf Coast Office Products.
Service Mastery Elite create clean, disinfected work environments. As a local business, we take pride in serving the New Orleans and Baton Rouge areas. Our cleaning protocols follow CDC and OSHA standards for healthcare settings, offices, senior living, restaurants, and industrial plants. Contact Service Mastery Elite to get your operation ready for reopening with germ disinfection cleaning. Service Mastery Elite, the trusted choice in professional cleaning since 1996.
This isn't just another day. It's so much more. Kelly's life was put on hold when her Ochsner primary care doctor discovered a rare blood disorder. Her doctor connected her to an Ochsner care team of cancer, heart, and kidney specialists. With multiple primary care locations around Baton Rouge, same-day appointments, and online scheduling, we're relentless about keeping you healthy. Ochsner Baton Rouge, innovating healthcare for Kelly.
Can you feel it? Spring is almost here, and if you got a new boat for Christmas or you just want to take your boat to a new level, you want front-to-back boat service, HD displays, live sonar that show the fish before you cast, trolling motors. At front-to-back, they got not one, but two NMEA-certified techs for all of your marine electronic needs. How does a brand-new speaker system sound? Well, guess what? They do that, too. So call 225-928-9644 or go to front...
After further review with Matt Moscona, presented by the Aesthetic Medicine and Anti-Aging Clinics of Louisiana, Baton Rouge, Lafayette, and online at theantiagingclinics.com. ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria.
All right, down the stretch, we come final segment here on a Thursday edition of AFR, presented by the Aesthetic Medicine and Anti-Aging Clinics of Louisiana. One thing left to do. Let's find out what we're betting on tonight. Time for Otter Locks.
Otter Locks.
Otter Locks.
Jimmy Ott joins us. Game time with Jimmy Ott follows us here in Baton Rouge. Otter, happy opening day. How are you?
Happy opening day. It's a new tradition. Go in your media room, put on four games, and listen to Moscona whine about the bullets in the strike zone, that it's out of the strike zone at Yankee Stadium today.
It was out of the strike zone.
I looked and I go, whoop, it was all in the red.
It was not all in the red. It was a bad call. How about that?
I'm sorry. Half of it was in the red.
Runner on second in the 10th. You're down a run and three straight clown strikeout. The hell is that, Otter?
Well, I mean, you know.
Hey, you mean, well, you know what? What kind of explanation is that? I mean, you know.
Under 95 and a half. We're off to a good start.
No, just 161 to go.
Like the Detroit Tigers official Twitter page tweeted out today, on pace to go 162-0. Go ahead, Detroit.
Not bad. do you think LSU baseball wins tonight?
No.
What about tomorrow?
No.
What about Saturday?
I would favor them in that game. Yeah.
All right.
It's a big drop-off.
They got to get there.
One and two pitchers to go up there. I mean, listen, not like LSU not throwing some good pitchers the first two games. And, you know, hey, well, a blooper falls in here, you know, whatever. We'll see.
You know the great thing, though, about Vanderbilt leading the SEC in ERA?
What's that?
They're also leading the SEC in batting average.
A run scored as well.
And they're fourth in the country in home runs.
They also lead the conference in scholarship allotment. And GPA.
There's a lot of schools that could do it, man. There's a lot of schools that could do it and choose not to. They've committed the resources. God bless them.
Tops is an asset.
There is no question LSU has had that benefit for a long time, too, and they have never – Hey, yeah. Never look like this, man. Not like this Vanderbilt team.
You know what another tradition is? Thursdays.
Jolie Pearl! Look at my guy. Always knows how to get the plug in. You know I know that. I was eye to eye with you, Otter. Fist bump. Fist bump through the phone. All right, what are we betting on tonight?
Well, Colucci is going to give out two more picks
at
6:30 tonight on the show as we broadcast here from Jolie Pearl. And he's with me tonight as well. But he did give out one that's gone at 6. In a couple of minutes, he's like the Montreal Canadian. Minus a nice price, about $1.80, $1.85. But we don't question the Colucci man.
All right. Just
roll with him. So.
All right. What else you got? Anything else, or are we just going with Colucci's pick?
Final four. You want that?
Yes. Hit me with your – yes.
Friday, you know? I mean, you know, every day's Good Friday. You abstain from meat and hot on every Friday. After further review.
Hey, you could always come by. We tried to do that one time, and I'm pretty sure you had already started sipping your margs. Probably about 6 hours prior by the time that we had said, it's like, yeah, maybe Otter Friday at 6 o'clock isn't the best way to go.
You judging? Huh?
Not at all, but I also have to, I got to do a little CYA here, Otter, you know what I mean? For you and for me.
I understand. I know one of those days I gave you Coastal Carolina plus the points against Kansas. How did that look in hindsight, huh?
Oh, in football?
Yes.
Win a chicken dinner!
Hey, I wish I could get them points again. No. But anyway, I am going to take the points on Saturday.
Right.
I was wrong because I'm like, why is this a single-digit line against USC? It's almost like it's a Roto-Rooter stinky line. But then they you know, Gonzaga covers easily, and they look great, obviously. So they said, okay, we're putting this one on Saturday at 14. We'll get split action. They have it. It's going up to 14.5. They're betting Gonzaga line. I have to take Mick Cronin and UCLA. They've held their last four opponents in the tournament to an average 22 points under their scoring average the last four games. That's Alabama in regulation also.
Yep.
But, I mean, I just got to think they can – man, that's just too much. 1972, the last time a team was favored by this much. UCLA was favored by 17 over a young Denny Crum in the Louisville Cardinals. They covered that day, by the way. They went on to win the title. But I'm going with Chuck, and I'm just laying Baylor as well. Identical teams, man. They play. They're tough. They're athletic. They defend. But Baylor can shoot, and Houston cannot.
All right.
So, and I'm going with UCLA and Baylor. And that's the game. We get the game we all wanted. Gonzaga's going to win. And I'm saying it's going to be about a 5.5-point favorite on Monday night, the Zags over Baylor.
All right, Otter, have a great Easter, man. Have a great show. We appreciate you as always.
Thank you, Matthew.
That is Jimmy Ott. Game Time with Jimmy Ott follows us in Baton Rouge or online at 1045ESPN.com. CB, you learn anything?
Ryan Clark has chirper ability.
Paulie?
I learned Riley Smith made an opening day roster.
See ya.
AFR.
As we get on down the road, we remind you about Shabills Tire and Auto Service, ShabillsTire.com. 18 locations in South Louisiana. You can find the location nearest you at ShabillsTire.com. And in particular, if you're on the West Bank of Baton Rouge, there in Port Allen, they are looking for an auto service technician. So if that's you and you want a career instead of a job, inquire online or in person. ShabillsTire.com, ShabillsTire.com. I remind you every day, Shabills has been locally owned for more than 50 years. They treat you like family because they are a family. They've been family owned and operated for 5 decades now. They're an awesome place to work. Not only do they have 401k retirement benefits, they've got health benefits. They've got an employee tool purchase program as well. There's so many great reasons to go to work at Shabills. If you are a qualified auto service technician, you're looking for work, Shabills is looking for you. ShabillsTire.com. Shabills, where we keep.
Gulf Coast Bank and Trust is giving our customers the power to bank anywhere, anytime during this challenging event. And we're right there with you. Our mobile banking app is a smart way to manage your money and time. Gulf Coast Bank and Trust, the bank that cares about you.
To the heroes who are working tirelessly to care for our communities, we thank you. We will never forget the countless hours you dedicated on the front lines, choosing to risk your own health to fight for our friends, neighbors, and family members.
I mean, you guys are out on the front lines fighting it.
We are grateful for your heroic acts and unwavering spirit. Together, we are overcoming this adversity and make our state healthy.